hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls whenever candlelights flicker, where the air is deathly still. That is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now. Our tour begins here in this gallery, where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state. Your cadaverous pallor betrays an aura of foreboding, almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Is this haunted room actually stretching? Or is it your imagination? And consider this dismaying observation. This chamber has no windows and no doors. Which offers you this chilling challenge: to find a way out. Of course, there's always my way. I didn't mean to frighten you prematurely. The real chills come later. Now, as they say, look alive, and we'll continue our little tour. And let's all stay together, please. There are several prominent ghosts who have retired here from creepy old crypts all over the world. Actually, we have 999 happy haunts here, but there's room for 1,000. Any volunteers? If you insist on lagging behind, you may not need to volunteer. And now, a carriage approaches to take you into the boundless realm of the supernatural. Take your loved ones by the hand, please, and kindly watch your step. Oh yes, and no flash pictures, please. We spirits are frightfully sensitive to bright lights. Do not pull down on the safety bar, please. I will lower it for you. And heed this warning. The spirits will materialize only if you remain quietly seated at all times. We find it delightfully unlivable here in this ghostly retreat. Every room has wall-to-wall creeps, and hot and cold, running chills. Listen.
Serpents and spiders, take tail of a rat. Call in the spirits wherever they're at. Rap on a table. It's time to respond. Send us a message from somewhere beyond. Goblins and ghoulies from last Halloween. Awaken the spirits with your tambourine. Creepies and crawlies, toads in a pond. Let there be music from regions beyond. Wizards and witches, wherever you dwell, give us a hint by ringing the bell.
The happy haunts have received your sympathetic vibrations and are beginning to materialize. They're assembling for a swinging wake, and they'll be expecting me.
Me, I'm the happy ghost who's materializing. Hey everybody. What's up? How's it going? What, I hope everybody is having, a good Thanksgiving, to those who are celebrating. We're gonna get started here with, some Clock Tower. Thank you, Cloudberry, for the tier one sub. I hear they're making a new game called Clork Tower. I'd be down to play a Clork Tower, game. But before we get started, I think there are some errant ghouls, in this mansion, in this house.
I dropped out again.
Hey, well, I mean, we could just play the fighting game and get really good at it.
Okay. Identify yourselves.
I forgot the name of the main character from Kill la Kill, and I was gonna say that.
PogChamp?
No.
Makoto Naegi.
I'm Makoto Naegi.
All right. What's your name? What's your other one? What's your name?
Oh my Jellicle name. My name is Robbie.
No, not you. The other one.
Yeah, oh, I'm sorry.
I'm Simon the Driller.
God, why are my friends such fucking dweebs?
No, your Jellicle name.
Oh, my Jellicle name?
Yeah.
Juicy Jeff.
Hello to my friends Jackson and Robbie. Thank you for joining me for this, the Clock Tower finale.
We're going until the end. No matter what.
Yeah, hang on. I just realized one thing is missing from this whole... Where'd it go?
Do you have props?
No, my map.
Oh.
Alright, there we go. Found it. Chat, let me know how everything sounds, because I've been on two streams now. With this microphone, and neither of them are my own. So let me know if there's anything that I need to adjust on my end. If I need to be quieter or louder, if my friends need to be louder or quieter. I mean, they could definitely stand to be quieter, but generally. everybody's saying that. Check my funny sound machine. You mean this one?
What was that little wet fart there?
That was the one that I have called. So I have hot chocolate high velocity, and then mm-hmm. I have one that plays in reverse, and I called it cold vanilla.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
See, it starts with that little like balloon sound.
It starts with that little like pucker.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're gonna get started playing Clock Tower. Oh god, wait, I just realized. Hang on. So this is gonna... I broke it. I just
okay,
remembered.
Okay, okay.
So you break? you're gonna have to bear with me for a second while we load the game up. I'm gonna have to... Where is it? Where... Oh shit, wait.
What'd you do?
Hold.
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
Be ashamed of what?
Why is it all the way over? What the fuck?
What'd you do?
What did you do? Is it fine? Oh, it's fine.
Oh.
Never mind.
You did it.
Alright, cool. Never mind. It's all good. Nothing happened. Don't worry about it. I probably need to lower the audio of the game, so pardon me while I do that.
I have our funny guide pulled up on one monitor, and I have every retailer in town pulled up on another.
Oh, man. And then I will show this to my friends.
Nice.
Oh, where do I put this?
Damn.
You got a third monitor, right?
Well, Jackson, what matters more to you, the stream or the PS5?
You're right.
Close up the PS5 stores.
You're right. Robbie, can you handle the guide?
Thank you, Panda Candace, for gifting a tier 1 sub to Ominous Bears. All right, let's get started with Clock Tower.
With the ending list.
With the ending list of Clock Tower. So the endings that we are missing are ending D, ending E, and... Last but not least, certainly, I would say last and most, ending S, which is not on this list.
No, okay,
so we need D, E, and S. All right, do you just want to jump into it first?
We need ending des.
Yeah, des.
Nihon no no minasan konnichiwa. Watashi wa Kiefer Sutherland des.
I'm, like, astonished you memorized that.
I know a little bit of Japanese, so... Alright, quick start. We're just diving right in.
Head first.
Alright. Turn this fucking light on.
Clear. Oh, I can buy one on eBay for $1,100.
Yeah, why... You've been, like, spending all this time looking for one of these, and why don't you just, like, give in? Like,
why don't I just buy one from a scalper?
Okay. So if I remember correctly, so the surprise ending that I got last time, wherein I just suddenly and abruptly died in the elevator.
Mm-hmm.
My understanding is that is because I picked up the fucking ham.
My understanding is that because you did pick up the ham and you tried to go give it to Simon and Simon wasn't there.
All right. Yeah, and like I spent a very long time in that playthrough not getting the ham.
Mhm.
And it wasn't until the end that I was like, maybe I should get the ham.
I think I suggested getting the ham too.
Yeah. So Robbie, so clearly Robbie's on the mansion's side.
You got a new ending, didn't you?
I did. No, you're right. I mean, it.
Boodle.
We accomplished our goal ultimately. If I remember correctly, the other things I needed to do was I needed On and Laura to die.
Yeah. So for. One of the two endings that we need to get in order to like get S to go, we need to have both of them die. Lot is able to die. Like you just need people to be dead. Lot, so like if you want to see Lot die, you can get him to die. But we need some of the girls to die. We need a majority of the girls to die. We need to go to the cage with Simon. So we need to do everything. Except we cannot go to the secret room where your father is.
Yeah.
So don't go to the secret room. It doesn't matter. And then we need to go to the second floor on the elevator instead of the third.
Okay. So All right, so everybody dies. Got it.
Yeah.
And I, okay. So, so we will, I guess just go see Laura die over here.
Yeah, go to the shower.
I like the song.
It's good. Look at that mode 7.
So how was y'all's weird holiday?
It was good. Had some good food. Felt fucking sleepy.
Oh yeah.
Just called a few folks. My roommate is making pulled pork in a slow cooker.
I saw it. It looks fucking good.
So we're gonna eat that. You saw?
Because they posted a fleet.
Oh, Jay posts fleets?
Yes.
I don't think I'm that's not, a good idea.
I'm not paying rent next month. they can fucking figure it out.
Oh, what? You're not looking at their fleets, Robbie?
No, I'm not looking at anybody's fleets.
Oh, you didn't see my one fleet I made.
No.
Oh man. I liked my fleet.
I'm sure your fleet was fucking hilarious, Jack.
It wasn't. It was just, if you're reading this, we're dating, so give me your credit card information, and I got a couple of DMs.
Damn, and you could check who read it too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you can be like, hey man, I saw you read it, so like, pay up.
Oh yeah, no, I did.
God, I hate fleets.
I know.
Fleets suck.
Can I hide under the bed?
I had
Oh, you can.
Yeah, you can hide under the bed. I had like almost like a heart attack because, you know, when on the Switch main menu you can have like the multiple users in the circles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My dumb brain when I was at my family function.
Wait, what the fuck was that sound?
Was he just laughing at himself in the mirror?
Maybe.
Was that the bird?
Maybe.
Oh, don't go. No. Oh no. Oh! Okay.
Oh, you're fine.
Jesus, I thought she died.
That's where that reference is from.
Oh Christ, dude.
Long story short, I thought they added stories to Nintendo Switch when I saw the user circle. I was like, what is happening?
Oh my god, where do I fucking go?
I don't know, she's orange now.
It's fine.
It's my orange attack.
Now you gotta look at my orange attack.
Wasn't there a bit in Undertale where you turn orange? Am I crazy?
No. I mean, yes, sorry. You are.
Sorry, I'm thinking Underfell.
No, you're not. Shut up. You're not thinking of Underfell.
You're not.
And I'll make sure you aren't, motherfucker.
I think we should be able to send harmful beam rays through Discord.
I can do that already.
Yeah, hey, that works.
Knock it off. Oh, I have some. Oh wait, I do. I have the nuke button. I'm not allowed to touch.
Can't press that one.
No, it's red all for right. A reason.
Stupid. All right. So does that mean he's gonna stop? Cause I pushed him over. No. Really? That wasn't enough for you?
It feels like the first one is always the hardest to get rid of.
Yeah, because like there's no, there's like nothing like, oh, he's that way now. Fuck. Oh, he's picking up the pace.
Is the brownout a real thing? I don't know. You tell me.
What are you talking about? Ow. Oh. Where's the rock? 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 Where's the rock?
Am I spawned in the other pile?
What other? Oh! Fuck this. Other pile?
Yeah, the one where there's no tunnel.
Oh, suck me.
Ominous Bear says, what the hell is a brown note? Does it just, like, make you shit? And it's like, yeah, that is actually just what that does.
That is what that is.
That's what the brown note is.
That is a real tone.
It's a frequency that just makes you shit. Where do I go? Where do I go? How am I supposed to? How am I supposed to lose them?
Just a rock.
It could be you're also too stressed out.
Fine. I'll just chill right here.
Just sit in the main way.
Bro, oh my careful. God. Bro, be careful.
It's okay, I'm playing chicken. Okay.
Most of the time, wasn't there anymore?
Yeah, that'd be funny. Did you guys... Dev, I think you saw my messages with Robbie. Did you see my message about what I was doing to my cousins with their Switch?
Oh, yeah,
you were kicking their ass in Smash Bros, right?
Yeah, you're beating their ass.
And then I got banned from the Switch.
Owned.
Well, they should be better.
The kids are just trying to have a fun time. What are you doing? I'm like, I'm playing the game. I'm having fun. I don't know what you're talking about.
You're going to learn today.
I let my nephew win every other game.
No.
But the games where I don't let him win, I go nuts.
Go nuts, I change
out. I whipped out the Duck Hunt.
Oh, God, not the...
It's a slaughter.
Don't do that.
Because, like, they want to play on my Switch, but I want to make sure they don't want to play that game anymore. So it's like, all right, you can win a few games, but then, like, I play, and then I make it so they never want to play that game ever again. At some point, my nephew was like, we could play Animal Crossing. And I was like, no, Animal Crossing is kind of a one-player game. And they're like, no, I saw my friend play two players. You can take the Joy-Con out and play it with two people. And I was like, God, they're fucking learning.
Damn it, they're smart now. Fuck.
Shocked that Jackson is mean to kids. I mean to my family. Because we do that.
I mean to kids.
Robbie's mean to children. And break out the cancel hashtag. Wouldn't be the first time. Let's go.
It's so easy to be mean to kids.
It's so easy. Listen. My cousin's range in between the ages of 13 and 17, it was fine.
Yeah, they're 13. So
they need to learn. Like you're not 17 coming up to me going, "Oh yeah, I know how to play Terry." I'm like, "Oh, do you? Do you know how to play Terry?" Okay.
Show me.
Show me right now how you play Terry, and I will also pick Terry.
If one of my nephews is like, do you want to play football? It's not fucking, this ain't tag football, right? You're getting sacked.
I will truck you. You will fall to the ground and cry.
And I'm killing you.
you will suffer concussion.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Being a little scissor guy.
A little scissor man.
He's not in this room. Okay, he's gone.
Cool, you can go get Rock, maybe.
Please let the Rock be here.
Was there like a Dwayne the Rock Johnson float in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade this morning?
I feel like I saw a picture of that, but I'm not sure if it was like
I don't think it was real this year. Or this year, or real, or whatever. Okay. The Rock was there. It just wasn't there because I was being chased.
Oh, apparently it was real.
What?
Do you want to play Animal Crossing?
What?
With your nephew?
No.
No.
Why? Only child? Why?
Because I'm an only child. It's my game.
Ooh.
I'm a child
You're
of five.
A spoiled brat.
I'm a child of five boys. I don't want to share my Animal Crossing either.
I'm an adult.
You're a brat.
Adults can
it's
be.
It's my Switch. Paid for it with money.
It was a fake balloon. They did like a. It was for an ad, for 30 Rock.
What?
Sorry, wait.
Baby Rock's still in the air? Wait.
Sorry, wait. Young Rock.
What the fuck?
Young Rock.
Which seems to be a documentary about The Rock.
Okay. Oh.
Is that the best name I could come up with?
What would you do? What would your name be?
I don't know. I'm not paid to make this shit up.
Mm.
They are.
And Johnson.
My Dwayne. Free analysis is that they could do better.
Robin being an only child makes so much sense. Why?
Stop diagnosing me.
Thank you, Squidly Diddly, for resubscribing to tier 1 for 5 months. Thank you, AMGG, for resubscribing to tier 1 for 6 months in a row. Thank you, Zed Stack, for resubscribing to tier 1 for 2 months. 8 Ribbon, for resubscribing to tier 1 for 5 months. And Monokuma Booty Cheeks, for following.
Love that name. Still.
Big fan.
I believe that's Zarya, right?
I think so, yes. All right.
Damn, I thought there was just a person out there named Monokuma Booty Cheeks.
Legal name. Can I look out the window and see her die? It's a swimming pool.
No, it's a window, silly.
A scream came from outside. Rule of threes. On. Dot. Okay. Okay. Got it.
Cool.
So she's not dead yet, right? She's kind of in like kind
no,
of
she's,
like.
No, she's dead.
Oh, I thought that was like Schrodinger's. Schrodinger's dead.
No, if you see someone and they are in this game, if you see someone and they are not alive, they are dead.
If you jump over the swimming pool and don't interact with it, you get a better powered jetpack later on.
Shut up. fuck Nicholas.
Download Cave Story for free. It's a free game, everyone. Did you know that? Did you know Cave Story is a free game?
Did you know anytime you see Cave Story on sale on any platform,
you could just play that game for free.
You could get it at a cheaper price.
Low price of free.
Not even as piracy. That game was just released for free. In its best version.
Yeah.
Still haven't played Cave Story.
It's good.
Bro!
Isn't Cave Story made by assholes? No, Cave Story was made by Studio Pixel and then was bought
by
Nicholas. By assholes.
It was bought by assholes.
Let's get one thing clear. Nicholas acts like they own Cave Story, which I guess from a legal standpoint they do, but that is not theirs.
So what was your response when you went bro when I said I'd never play Cave Story?
I want to play Cave Story. I think after Fire Emblem, I'm gonna play Cave Story.
Sure, okay. Fuck it, go for it.
And there are text boxes in that game with character portraits.
There are.
I'll voice the main character. Quote.
Yeah, great.
Quote what?
Quote
unquote.
What are we quoting?
Was it ever talked about? I don't think anybody in the game says quote, right? Like, that was just, like, a thing in the...
I think that was just, like...
Thing in the back of the box.
Yeah, something or other.
You're continuing Fire Emblem? Bro, I can't... I haven't stopped thinking about Fire Emblem.
Robbie has said multiple times, as like, I can't stop thinking about Fire Emblem. And I'm like, who am I talking to?
It's like, the first one is just... It's so cute.
It's cute. It's really cute. Cuz
like even like when I was a kid, like I got the you know, like those packs, like those PC packs that have like a bunch of Sega Genesis games on them.
Yeah.
One of them was Shining Force.
Oh.
And like I played Shining Force and like really liked the character sprites.
Yeah.
But like I didn't get far in that game cuz I didn't know how to fucking play it. But it just reminds me of like playing one of those old strategy games. Which I never got to really play. I never got to experience.
Right.
man, but I just like looking at those sprites and having characters with names in it. I miss Bart, dude.
Damn it, there's nothing in... Fuck.
Don't you got a Pug with a stick?
No, so this is one of the places where the West Wing key could spawn, and it didn't.
Oh, damn. Shoutouts to Doga.
Shoutouts to Doga.
You are never gonna fucking believe what just happened.
What happened?
I took Romeo...
Check it out, Meeks is here, everybody. Say hello to me.
I took Romeo outside.
Yeah.
He wanted to walk up the street, so I said, okay, let's walk up the street.
Yeah.
Out of absolutely nowhere, this giant dog comes running down the street and attacks Romeo.
What do you mean attacks Romeo?
Like, he goes right for Romeo. Romeo's screaming.
He wasn't attacked, man. He just wanted to play.
Romeo did not want to play. Romeo was barking.
What if it was the same dog? Back for revenge.
He was crying. Romeo was crying.
Oh,
he was
get
terrified.
Over it. Get over it, baby.
You wouldn't hear Romeo cry the way he cried. Don't say that.
I heard him cry before when it happened with the other big dog.
And then when I walked away, Romeo went...
Bro, the dog's already got two dads. Don't invalidate its trauma now.
He'll get over it. He's got to be friends with dogs. He'd just be scared of them.
Well, he's scared of them. I don't know what to tell you. He's got anxiety.
All right, dog's traumatized.
Cool, you have a gay traumatized dog.
It's over.
It's over.
It's over.
It's over. Your dog's gay and traumatized. That's what it gets for having two Italian dads.
There's nothing wrong with having two Italian dads.
Oh, really? Let me look at Romeo.
Romeo's fine.
Is he, though?
He'll be fine.
He grows up, torture small animals, light small fires.
How does a dog light a fire?
Average IQ.
What is a dog's IQ?
Average.
If Doga dies, can you uninstall the game and play Lego Island 2? No. Doga won't die.
Yeah, that's
Doga
just
can't die.
What did I tell you? Ghosts can't die.
God.
Alright, now we go back to the kitchen. With the insecticide.
Devils never cry, lady. But what if, Dante? Devil may cry.
What?
There she goes.
What are you doing?
I'm losing my mind. I'm looking at the retailers.
can you stop talking about bad Capcom game, please?
Oh, sorry.
We'll Haunting Ground, my bad.
It's talking about good ones like Haunting Ground.
We got Chase to, by the way, if y'all didn't see Chase's stream the other day.
We got him.
We got Chase to consider playing Haunting Ground. Which was the goal.
So be ready to see Chase's last stream before his channel gets taken down.
Oh my god, I can't wait, dude.
I don't think there's anything that bad.
She gets way too comfortable with that dog.
You can play League of Legends. And, like, League of Legends has, like, fucking Evelynn in it.
Yeah, let me just get too comfortable with Poppy or whatever and fuck her name is.
What? Poppy's the Smurf.
Teemo.
Teemo's the animal. The little, animal.
Can you shut up, please? What are you doing?
The dog?
Shut up. Jesus Christ.
The dog's a ghost.
Warwick.
All right, you can fuck.
Enough! Jesus H.
You only look out for Chase's on the
stream. Yeah, check that out.
Which room is it? No.
What room are you looking for?
No, it's one upstairs. I know what I'm doing.
Poppy the troll? No, Trundle's the troll. Poppy is a Yordle.
Yeah, please.
Please.
There's one thing that I won't tolerate is incorrect.
Misinterpreting League of Legends lore.
Yeah, please.
Just fucking turn on the escalator.
Bro, why do you need a house this big?
You don't.
Just pay $200 a month for one room.
Thank you, Chase, for resubscribing it to your own for 6 months. Hey guys, check it out. I found a Mega Man game. Look, it's in Japanese. Spider-Man. Don't know what that means, Chase, but thanks.
Last night, Chase was showing us around Japan on Google Maps. And I was talking about how bad I want to go to a recycling store, like hard off.
Oh, this shit.
And specifically, I would bring up some videos that I've seen on YouTube where white dudes will walk through hard off and like show off like hard off. And there was one video in particular I remember where a guy is walking through it and is like skipping past all of the really cool things just to look at like Mario games.
You've talked about stuff like this before.
And I never watched all the way through the video when he goes upstairs to the toy section, but at some point he's like, yeah, check out the big Gundam wall here. You can like get like a bunch of Gundams for real cheap, real old ones too. Oh, check it out. X-Men. And he looks at like Spawn figures and Spider-Man figures for like 10 minutes. He'll grab like a really like huge clean box of Hokuto no Ken figures and be like, I don't know what that's from. Oh, bro, Star Trek. Like it anytime you like went by extremely rare looking games or like things that never came out in America for super cheap, he'll immediately pan the camera down and be like, oh, dude, Mega Man on Game Boy. Like, are you fucking kidding? I got so fucking mad. At some point, he went back to the X-Men aisle and looked at more Spawn figures.
That had to have been on purpose. I don't believe. No, I
Cube. No. You got. I will watch the video. It is not. It is genuine.
It is a genuine.
I truly believe that there are plenty of dumbass white people who just go to Japan because it's like a thing that it's like cultural or whatever.
I'm sending Cube the video.
Mother, dude walked by like a whole like end cap shelf and was like, I guess this is Sailor Moon or whatever. None of it was Sailor Moon.
Pans the camera up and there was Sailor Moon and they walked by. Oh my god, it was fucking infuriating. In the thumbnail, insane Japanese retro video games, toys, and more hard off hobby off extended walkthrough. In the thumbnail is him in front of the store, and then to the side of him was the fucking Boba Fett jet fighter that he was like really into.
There's a Boba Fett slave one. Look at that, good condition.
And then he rubs it all over the ground because he can't pick it up with one hand. Oh.
You started another video as well with another dumb white dude walking in to like the bottom floor of Hard On or whatever, or Hard Off or whatever. I'm tired. Hard Off. How did that conversation end? What did I say to you? I'm like, I can't take this anymore. Fuck you. Good night.
You said I can't take it anymore. Then you left. You missed a really good quote from that. The end. He was like, oh wait, I wanted to save the best for last. Check this out. And then he like looks down and he's like, cause he obviously comes to Hard Off a lot. And this is the one thing he always picks up and looks at. He picks up and he goes, check it out. The Simpsons. probably the most American cartoon I could think of.
Bro,
look on the Simpsons in Japan, dude.
He goes, the Simpsons, but it's like in Japanese. And look here on the side, on the spine, what does that say? Za Simpsonzu.
bro, they got fucking Kazuku no Simpsons. Crazy.
Fucking, I was like, you don't get out of there, please. He was like, he walked through a corner of the store and he was like, whoa, you guys remember Laserdiscs? Man, if I had a Laserdisc player, this would be cool. And the whole wall was anime Laserdiscs. Like super fucking old, like vintage ass big box laser discs of like fucking animes I've never heard of. And he was like, yeah, but that's pretty cool for anybody that likes laser discs. Anyway, check out these old vinyls, Pink Floyd.
I hated them. There was one dude that knew what he was talking about. That was like a palate cleanser. It was like, okay, yeah.
It was an actual like retro games collector. So he was like very cleanly going through like the TurboGrafx stuff and like the Wonder Swan he showed.
Oh man, I want to fucking
fight elite stick that I have not seen in my lifetime, and I'm like, those are real.
There's a Soul Edge fight stick that he fucking went right by.
I want a PC Engine, I think.
They're cheap?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You can get a Japanese one, you can get it for like $30.
It's cheaper than fucking TurboGrafx.
Yeah.
My understanding is that the games, on the other hand, are...
That's where you're gonna be spending some money, but...
Yeah. Could just get a flash cart.
Always. Is someone clean? Is that a clean puppy?
You want to know what he does when I'm done washing him?
What?
I get the towel out and he jumps right in my arm.
Oh,
what a clean
little dog. When he's clean, he's running around, you gotta be like, oh, look at the handsome boy.
Okay, so now I'm just going downstairs.
Yeah.
Alright, cool. Oh wait, I need the ceremony key still.
He was so scared.
Ceremony key.
Wow.
You got your staff, right?
Oh no, I need that too.
Wet.
I'm sorry, so I need the I need the staff. I need the ceremony key.
Dry out his ears.
What room are you? You are the... Okay. Nothing. Nothing I need in here. Are you the clown room?
Are you the clown?
No, this is the ceremony room. Are you the clown room?
Isn't it in conjunction with, like, the fireplace room?
It is, so it's upstairs.
We do this every time.
You know, I feel like I go for my map, but it's, like, it's not to... You know how, like, how sometimes you, like, kind of chew gum when you study? So that way, if you chew gum during a test, it, like, gives you, like, kind of that association? Romeo.
No, but I understand what you mean.
Because now he's feel... like he popped shit now that he's home. So now he's barking at the dog.
Hang on. I feel like that's kind of why I pull out the map. I never actually refer to the map. I feel like the act of taking it out just helps me recall
where you are.
Certain landmarks.
All right.
Hey, we're popping.
Okay.
Go in that room.
Yeah, so do not go in this room. Well, I mean, I can go in that room, but there's... Alright, so... This way over here.
Oh, they got Nintendo Switch lights for sale!
Yeah, get yourself a Switch Lite.
There's no cross save.
Those are cute little systems.
They are.
My hands are too big. Like even the normal Joy-Con is too small for me.
Jesus.
I know.
Can we switch?
Yeah.
Finally the lantern shows up.
Yeah.
You want it?
I don't need it. I'm not doing fucking anything that would require it. Hi, Chase. Let me pick up the key. Feels like someone's watching.
Someone's watching me. It's a big fucking clown looking at me. Oh.
Honk, honk, honk.
I always feel like there's a fucking clown at me.
Oh, hey. I didn't know you were actually still here.
Oh.
Oh, whoa. There's a funny doll flying at me. And now a QTE.
Raging demon. Oh.
Whoa.
QTE.
Fuck. I fucked up.
Oh.
Wait, I'm alive?
Yo, she got meter.
I'm alive.
Check it out. Idiot. She didn't turn around. Could have just turned around.
Did you even pick up the key?
I did. Because you pick up the key and that's what triggers the doll.
I thought it was always in the doll.
No, it's in the drawer. It's underneath the clown.
Chase, that clown ass is sitting on it. Release those fucking animals.
Do I need to?
Let's see. Yeah, just in case.
Alright, sure.
Like I said, this is the only guide that like specifies what you need to do, but then it's just like follow the directions for ending D, follow the directions for ending F, but do this, follow the directions for ending A, but do this.
Okay.
Free my friends.
The birds! The birds!
Alright, get out of here.
Yeah.
Get out of here. Go. Just get out of here, you big dumb animal.
Go on, get.
Sorry,
Romeo.
You stupid dumb animal.
So I think.
You get your funny scepter, your funny key.
Trying to remember where the. I think the piano room is downstairs. Or maybe it's right here. Chase, what are you up to right now? Hi, Romeo.
Hi, Romeo.
Talk to your family for Thanksgiving. Did you explain to them the JoJo's egg?
Did you talk about Kakyoin laying the egg or not?
Fuck this. Stop laughing at me. Oh my God! Call him back. Call him back. Right now.
Leave your mom a voice memo. Just be like, hey.
Give them a call. Be like, hey, yo, ma, you gotta get the Zoom back together. One last heist. Baby. Putting my nieces and nephews to bed. Wake them up.
Tell them too.
It's fine. Oh, guts room.
Guts.
What are you barking at? You are so pissed off.
Hey, bro, check it out. Look. Berserk.
You made nasty yourself.
Boba Fett, slave wild.
Oh shit, dude! It's a Boba Fett slave boy.
Check it out. I'm here in a bookstore. Yo, dude, check it out. Dragon Ball Z.
At some point, he did like pass by other anime figures and be like, "Look, Dragon Ball."
Dragon Ball, some other anime, and it's all JoJo.
Yeah, he looked at a giant cabinet of like rare JoJo figures. It was just like.
It's just some anime stuff.
Nintendo,
and then he said some anime stuff. He said some anime stuff, and then he pans the camera 180 degrees, squats down, and he goes, "Oh, look, they got Toy Story here, Buzz Lightyear, Woody. They got a lot of stuff." He pans the camera to the right. He gets those fucking rare vinyl Earthbound figures. Anyway, X-Men.
Ah.
It stung. It stung, and they were like $10 each.
Stop.
Oh, they got magic cards here.
Oh, they got Yu-Gi-Oh. I don't play a lot of card games.
magic?
Yu-Gi-Oh.
Oh, they got these like... rare Tamagotchi. All of them are broken. This one says okay, though.
He was like, he walks in, and to the left is just like a bunch of claw machines and Taiko. Then at the end of the video, he's like, "Yeah, and here's all the claw machines. I'm not really good at them, though, so I don't play." It doesn't, like, show the prizes in them or what you can win.
Oh, because I can't win them, so I don't want to.
That's why, like, truly, who'd you make that video for?
To show off that he is in Japan and you're not.
Maybe. I mean, maybe he lives there. Will you post this vid somewhere? I feel like that it's, if I talk shit about a video, then I feel like it's rude for me to post it. I am speaking generally about video reviews of people like American people going into Hard Off, and showing it off, because like sometimes you get people who really like give a shit about collecting, and yeah, they, like, know what they're talking about, but other people very obviously are just in there just to show a recycling store, and not really know what the hell they're talking about.
I feel like if I went there, I would like look for things that had cool box art and like grab them.
He was like,
yeah, this section has a bunch of full box N64 games.
And he pulls out one and he's like,
no, God,
I don't know what that says. Look, this one's Star Wars.
I was saying, like, if I was in that store, my fingerprints would be on every single fucking item.
It's true.
Chad, if you want to see these videos, Hard Off walkthrough, I think is what I searched.
You can find them.
Yeah.
Really messes me up because he's like walking down the aisle and it's like there's all the Star Wars figures, like all these vintage Star Wars figures. It's the fucking like episode 1, episode 2 stupid action figures they made.
Yeah.
And then he pans over and on the other side of the aisle is a bunch of like Figma and Nendroid, like still in box, like
yeah, full stuff. In box Nendos, like Miku ones too, like
Miku. Pretty. I saw a Bloodborne one and I was like,
Oh, Romeo's pissed.
Romeo's pissed that he didn't get to see.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a nap right here and get infected by demons.
Back to Japan and film one of those specifically to piss people off. Don't you do that.
You could just have fun instead.
You could just go to Hard Off and get cool things.
One day I'm gonna give Chase just like $200. Just be like,
that's what I said.
Any sofa B you see in there, just fucking buy.
I saw a thing where Capcom announced that they were doing Capcom was doing their own like Toreba. Mm-hmm. But for like specifically their own merchandise,
yeah.
I was like halfway tempted to be like, "Hey, Chase," because I think the problem is that they're like all the like auto translated descriptions I could find seem to suggest that they don't ship internationally.
Yeah.
So it would have to be like a Japanese address.
My baby.
So do I need to see Lot die?
No, but just don't bother looking at Lot. Just keep going.
Fuck Lot.
Is the fuck Lot gang?
This is the fuck Lot run?
Yeah, cause I fuck a lot.
Nice.
Thanks.
Wait, did you go give Simon the ham and stuff or no?
I thought you said not to. You're leading me astray.
Whatever, just do it.
No,
should
this
be fine.
This has.
Beef.
Eat beef.
Beef.
Stupid idiot.
It's a dog. It doesn't know any better.
It's gonna learn today. Nope.
I'll learn how to do a fucking infinite. I should have found some way to bring like Marvel 3 to the family function and do infinites on the kids.
Look, it's X-Men.
You want to play the Dreamcast? I mean, well, okay.
Look, it's the X-Men. The what? And that's when I actually physically hit them.
Right.
I think it's fair if children don't know what the X-Men are.
I think it's fine. I think the X-Men can die. I only say this as somebody who didn't grow up on X-Men.
I just mean, like, I feel like the only recent exposure for children to have of the X-Men would be the fucking, I mean, I guess Ultimate Alliance 3 and then, like, the most recent, like, Fortnite collaborations.
Rise of the Phoenix, the shitty X-Men movie or whatever.
I guess. Hang on, let me just take a... Let me just take a quick nap before baby.
Wolverine.
I was severely shocked they put anything to do with the X-Men in Ultimate Alliance 3.
It was shocking. Yeah, that was crazy.
In Fantastic Four. Oh my god, it's the Blob from X-Men.
It's the Blob from X-Men. Oh, it's Boba Fett Slave 1. Oh, yo, check it out. Captain Saber. Bro, look at how Star Wars.
Well, they got droidicas from episode 1.
Go!
I think if you're not in the mindset of going to one of those places, being like, I'm trying to find something rare, but you're walking around, you're like, hey, I recognize this. Oh my god.
Bro, what are they feeding him?
Bro.
Besides people.
What are they feeding him? They should just stop feeding him, period.
Well... Now they are.
All right, now we go to the second floor.
Alright. Then, we'll see if we die, I guess.
We do the Hadouken.
Yeah, we learn the Satsui no Hado.
Dr. Light gives us the final piece we need to do the Hadouken.
Please. God damn it!
You got to feed him the ham.
I thought it was because I did feed him the ham last time.
Oh. Maybe you gotta feed him the ham.
I'm not fucking watching this whole opening again.
But what about? Well, what about the post-credit scene where she actually lives and it was just a big ol' thing of cranberries?
Happy Thanksgiving! Bobby, happy got all the cranberry sauce everywhere!
you fucking fool!
I'm sorry, this is my first Thanksgiving, I don't really know what I'm supposed to be doing.
Oh, Bobby, here, why don't you do the first cut on a turkey with your big ol' scissors?
I'm really good at carving.
Yeah, carve me a big old piece for the clock tower baby.
Oh, we got a big turkey for Dan. All right, let's second verse right. Same as the first. Check it out, speed run.
It's like an emaciated monkey. What are you doing? Oh, he brought ham, everyone.
Thank you, Momo, for the $5 donation. This game stresses me out real bad, but I popped in because I wanted to support either way. Have a good playthrough. Don't die, please. Well, bad news.
Bad news.
You can't go in the secret room. You gotta get thrown into the jail cell with Simeon.
Okay.
You gotta get thrown in there. You can't physically
I request a different pronunciation.
It's the Halloween hack. Now get ready for Clock Tower Thanksgiving hack. That sounds so cute.
Yeah, and the language will be wonderful.
Yeah, I'll make it.
So in that case, I guess I should go... Well, because if I need to get thrown in, then I need to make sure that I get caught by Miss Mary, right?
You gotta get drugged by Miss Mary.
But then...
You gotta get on the lower die. You can't go to the secret room. You gotta get dropped by Mary. Then you gotta go meet Simon.
So, but how do I make sure that I see Miss Mary when I go in that room? What? Why is the music already starting? What? Wait, whoa, wait, whoa, whoa, why? Whoa, wait a second. Hang on, buddy. You're jumping the gun. You're jumping the gun. Nobody's died yet. Nobody's died yet, dude.
You're going to be the first.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Laura's the protagonist now.
Nagito, hello, Jennifer. Nagito, I'm talking to you. Whoa. How do I get out of this clock tower? Oh my god, what the f-
Who tied me up in this clock tower?
Oh, this ringing is so annoying. Fucking A.
Oh, where's the switch?
Where's the PS5?
that's the Thanksgiving gag.
I know they're going in stock soon, and I will order one and go pick it up within the next 5 hours. All those idiots lined out front are gonna get turned away because they're not.
Hey! Hey, Jennifer!
Oh my god.
Where are you? Is that the bird or is that him?
I think that's him looking in the mirror, going, like, hyping himself up, going, yes, I can do this! Or he sees sees the reflection of yourself under the bed.
How would he see that, though?
I don't know. It's Bobby. Chat, what do we do if we see somebody looking at their hand and also holding big scissors?
Son of a bitch, dude.
Now you gotta look at my orange. Oh my god.
Bitch.
Nice.
Bobby Dog Clock made.
Wait! Bro, what fucking teleportation magic do you have?
Maybe I teleported?
No, God, no, no, fuck, he really is Kamaida, no! He learned the secret!
Come back here, Jennifer!
He learned the secret of the funhouse! No!
Why are you running from me?
You better run faster! I'm getting closer, Jennifer!
That's the demon that Miss Mary summoned, was Nagito.
Oh, fuck this. Bro, fuck this, dude. And the phone's ringing. Hey,
Chase, you're not doing anything. Make an edit so that a tier 2 emote is just the hand. You do that right now.
Please, yeah, right while now. while you have the time.
You got partner.
Yeah,
you have that instant gratification. All right, maybe we can float again. Get up. Just checked in with Ojimakondi in my house. I can get you a new PC Engine inbox for $350. That's a lot of money.
You can get them for cheap if you just get them loose.
Can I, like, kick this ladder down?
You asked that last time, and the answer was yes. And then you started walking on air.
No. Go up, Jennifer. Nope. Oh, God.
Hello.
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, bye.
No, it's okay. I think he's... No, wait, he's leaving.
Sheriff Frog says, please no hate, but who is Nagito? I would never hate you for asking that question.
Nagito Komaeda is a character from Danganronpa 2 Goodbye Despair.
Bless you for asking that question, as a matter of fact.
Mm-hmm.
All right. He's
anyway, now we can start the playthrough.
The playthrough can now begin. What the fuck, dude? What happened? So that was on, yeah?
That was on. Now you gotta go find Laura.
Wait.
Mm.
Ham.
I gotta bring the ham to the party.
I forgot, it's Thanksgiving, but I don't have the ham.
Gotta remember this place is an octagon.
Why is it that we eat turkey on Thanksgiving, like the driest meat?
It's a holiday founded by white people.
It's a holiday perpetuated by white.
I looked it up. Christopher Columbus is not that Italian, okay?
But he not still is the best Italian in history.
He's not Italian at all, isn't he? Isn't he Spanish?
He came for it. He traveled from Italy, I think, is how the story goes.
He was a Spanish explorer that sailed out of Italy.
Okay.
Just throwing that out there.
So Mussolini.
Well,
is now
we'll take it back then. I don't know.
Mussolini has been bumped to number one.
Cowboy Curtis and John Wayne the Genie. Dumb joke, please.
Okay, mine wasn't gonna be much better. I was gonna ask, has there been an Ultimate Showdown reanimated yet?
No, that'd be such a good idea though.
Alright. Nobody take that.
Yeah, the chat sit on that.
Where am I going?
Sit on and spin.
I forgot.
You have the ham. What are you missing?
I need the key. That's what I wanted to do.
Do you have the robe? You have the perfume? You have the insecticide?
No.
You have the robe?
No. Okay. Slow down, cowboy. Okay. Good. I got the key. No, I don't have the cod robe bag yet.
Don't got the hot dog?
I don't got the... Hey, Jennifer, why don't you have a hot dog?
Nice bread. Why are you so excited about bread? Why are you so excited about ham?
Costco's the one in the cage.
Yeah. Not emaciated or hunger or anything. He's just been locked in there.
Jennifer wakes up and he's like, yo.
Yeah. Hey, new to the cage, huh?
Fucking headbutts her.
Does a dropkick move? Who has better dropkicks, Ichiban or Kiryu?
Oh. I feel like this is a loaded answer. I feel like if I answer the wrong way, you're going to kill me.
I feel like it's up to discussion.
Mm. I don't know, because it feels better to actually be able to run and do a dropkick as Kiryu.
And Kiryu does a cool backflip after he does a dropkick.
Yeah, you can get it.
Whereas Ichiban just kind of puts his whole body into it, which is kind of how Kiryu did it in Zero.
That's how Kiryu does it until you get the upgrade.
Yes, but he also starts doing that just in 3, I think, is just when he starts doing dropkick backflips.
Well, that is, I gotta play more 3.
Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, Ichiban imagines most of the fight in his head, so, like...
Before he started doing that, you can upgrade the regular freelance style... And that's where you actually get his drop kick in that job. So technically, you can be doing drop kicks before you start playing hero.
Well, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I feel like they're kind of going for the drop kick being Ichiban's like signature move. He does it in almost every cinematic. So like.
Yes, that's true. What would you say is Kiryu's signature move?
He does like that kind of like charge up Superman punch where he reams his whole body like 90 degrees and then punches.
Okay.
I mean, besides his combo being like the punch, punch, kick, follow up kick, and then the fucking bicycle kick that he does where he flips forward. I like to think it's like, yeah, there's just like that big old punch. And I feel like that's accentuated in Yakuza 6, where heat moves are replaced with heat mode. And like, you, when you do like a big punch in heat mode, you have to like mash triangle.
Those feel good.
Yeah.
I like those in Kiwami too. No. Oh, wait, I already have the West Wing key.
What about the tiger drop? Yeah. I mean, that's also just like a big punch.
Yeah, I was actually going to say I feel like the tiger drop is also pretty high up there. Also, just because the tiger drop is very funny.
It's in almost every game.
Apparently there's an Ultimate Shonen animated being worked on. Fuck.
Sick.
Well, shit.
Open up. Pulled pork ready? Pulled pork's ready, everybody!
Oh, fuck.
Pulled pork's ready!
Everybody say hi to Jay Bear Hat. Jay Bear Hat.
Hi, Jay Bear Hat.
I made Thanksgiving pulled pork. I don't know if they can hear me.
They can hear you.
We can hear you. Welcome back to Twitter.
Don't whisper.
Fucking
I made Thanksgiving pulled pork. Thanksgiving.
Dev said they saw your pulled pork on one of your fleets.
Yeah. I put it on fleet.
Why?
One's there.
Because I'm not allowed to put death threats on there.
I was taking photos for my mom. My mom wanted to see the cooking.
And then you thought this would make a good fleet?
And then I clicked the fleet button on accident and I said, well, what photos?
No, you did. I'm going to get some pulled pork.
yeah. Stop fucking arguing. Go eat the fruit that you were just made. Bitch. All right, so. What's
okay,
up?
Okay, let me read this guide section first before I say my piece. Okay, don't acknowledge the secret room. Okay. So now you need to get captured by Miss Mary. Did you see Laura die yet?
I saw On die.
Alright.
So I might not. That might be a problem.
Might be.
If I go into the room and I don't see Miss Mary, I'm just gonna restart. How's that sound?
Might as well. Here's my piece. I'm having a hard time getting into Yakuza 7.
Because it's a JRPG?
Yeah, because like I'm going into the mindset of like, yeah, I'm gonna play Yakuza game, but it is a JRPG, and I don't think I have the patience right now to like progress through a JRPG.
That's fair.
So like I played through No More Heroes 1 and 2 as fast as I did because they're not turn-based RPGs.
Thank
it's
you.
Just
oh
Jesus
my
Christ,
God.
Chase.
I wonder if it should. Oh man. I wonder if maybe you should make. I wonder if you should zoom in the. Holy shit, Chase. I wonder if you should zoom in the Nagito head. So that
maybe.
Way the face is a little
just
bit more defined.
But. No, everything that I have done of 7, I've loved and enjoyed, but it's just. It's hard to build a momentum that makes me want to keep playing that game.
Yeah, you definitely need to kind of like be in the mode to play
like,
it.
Okay. Because there was a week where I played Persona 5 and Persona 5 R straight, and those are the only two games I played, and I beat them both, and I was like, cool.
I think it also from the sounds of it, it also just might be kind of a conflict with how you seem to play games.
Yeah. Or just go at them for hours at a time.
Yeah. Of like, if you kind of, it seems like you kind of try to beat them in very relatively quick sittings, and if you can't, then you don't really want to.
I don't think it's that. I think it's just I think with RPGs, yeah, because I did that with Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Yeah.
Where I went in thinking was like, oh yeah, this is just gonna be the RPG, da da da, like, but then I remembered like, oh no, wait, I don't need to have it turn based. This is just kinda like combat whatever.
Yeah.
And that let me space it out for another week. I don't know. I might, if all else fails on getting this PlayStation, I'm gonna give it a little bit of reprieve and just sit down and play Yakuza 7.
All right, great.
Oh my
Chase,
God,
thank
Chase.
You.
That's perfect.
All right, let's see. Please, Miss Mary. Fuck.
Knock over the suit of armor.
Yeah, but I thought I needed to get abducted.
You do. So let's see if you can knock over the armor, see if Laura's dead, walk out, and then walk back in. Because it does reset the room.
Oh, that's true. Alright. Well, I'll see ya. Alright, let me get the key. Should I get the key first, or...?
Maybe, yeah.
Actually, no. I'll just walk out. Walk back. Miss Mary? Yes!
Yeah, there you go.
Alright, cool. We're on track. Oh, then Lot's gonna die. God, I love how, like, much darker her portrait is than Jennifer's.
Just like, yeah, the lighting coming from the side of her as opposed to Jennifer where it's head on.
Yeah.
Everything is going to be just fine. Miss Simpson? Are you thirsty? Drink this rat poison. Here, drink this.
Oh. Here, drink this. Okay.
Oh.
I said drink it, not down it.
Idiot. Here, eat this onions. No.
Bite this onions. Oh, bro, what
the
fuck
part
happened?
Of this onion.
Alright.
Oh my God, it's a monkey.
Hey, what's up? Who are you?
Oh.
Here.
This emaciated ape man.
Who are you?
Simon Barrows.
This man is Barrows?
Yes.
I just remembered funny joke.
Horse walk into bar. Bartender asks why long face. Horse kick hole in jukebox and leave.
Man walk into bar. Man say ow. Alright.
What difference between a hippo and Zippo?
What's the difference?
One a little lighter.
Thank you, Dragon Cat Man, for gifting a tier 1 sub to Cuboid. Hey, Lot.
F a sec. I'll get you out.
Hang on, there
we
I'll
go.
I'll get you out in a sec.
Get out of here before Mary comes.
I'm getting my escape next. Hey, I doubt it.
Hey, I doubt it.
Alright.
Quickly, Yennefer.
Alright, bye.
Oh shit.
Oh fuck.
Oh fuck. Miss Mary's class.
I got so caught up in what I was doing, I forgot all about it. She's gonna kill me.
Oh shit, she's gonna kill me.
If I don't flip this 2x4, Miss Mary will flip out. Alright. Now we leave.
Now we live.
I feel like I got this ending already, I thought. No. I didn't. Did I?
It's no, you did not. It's where I'm trying to get you to go into ending B. Okay. Which is a different ending from C. That looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Now he's still looking at his fucked up hand, his little homunculus friend in his hand.
Alright, so...
Bro, just put the PlayStation in stock. I'm sick of this.
Five Nights at
Freddy's. I didn't mean to hit that one.
Five Nights at Freddy's.
That's where we want to be. Five.
What, Jack Black, what ending would this be? Thank you. Where am I fucking going?
You need to get either the staff or the demon idol, depending on what it tells you.
All right, let me go to the... Jack, you okay?
Hello.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing.
How's the pulled pork?
It's really good.
Jack, are you okay? You sound like you're like hyperventilating. Is Jack?
What's that noise?
Jack?
Five Nights.
Jack?
Okay, you just turned into sand.
Oh no!
The transformation.
Jack, after not surviving.
Oh, did Chase make a Nagito hand?
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, it says tier 2.
Alright, good.
Alright. They have been rescued. Mm-mm.
If anybody's a tier 2 sub to Chase and also a sub to me. Oh, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Chase.
Way ahead of you.
My thank you.
What emotes do I have going on for me?
Real quick, someone give me a tier 3 sub to don't actually do that. Never mind. That's a bit that I don't want to pay off. Oh, okay. I feel like Chase should get a Monokuma badge, like a sub badge. It's my personal opinion.
Oh.
Oh?
Hello?
Oh.
Hi.
Hi.
Thought Jack Black got you.
He did. Bye.
Oh. This
okay.
is the
goal Hello?
Line music.
Hello?
Hey, what's up?
All right, we're
Hello.
Back.
Hello.
All right. Back to it.
Okay.
What was the last thing I said?
Stream of conscious, I don't remember.
Okay. Last thing I said was, I feel like Chase should, get a Monokuma, son of a bitch, it's a demon idol. I feel like Chase should have a Monokuma sub badge.
That's fucked up.
What do you mean?
Like, if you're sub for, like, 2 years, it just turns into Monokuma?
I didn't think 2 years.
I'm thinking 2 years.
Alright, well, you're a psychopath.
Twisted
no.
Psychopath.
If you're sub to Chase for 2 years, you're a psychopath.
That's true. I'm not going at all in on Danganronpa. Okay, but you like Monokuma is the thing. This has been established.
Yeah.
They're established. Sick twisted.
Rude. What do you mean rude? It's not
I think it's because I called all of Chase's subs.
Oh. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That's a little rude. Fucking, I have to be like sub to Lathero for like 2 years before I can get his Magatama sub badge.
Oh my god, yeah.
Well, time travel.
Jump. Oh, nice.
You fucking made it.
Oh, idiot. Oh boy, now how do I get over?
Oops.
How do I? Oh wait. What do I? Actually. This presents a problem.
Can you use the rope to grab the board?
Hang on. First, I need to.
Have you ever jumped that before?
No.
Damn.
You're the demon idol.
Jennifer's learning.
Betwixt her bosom.
Yeah, I'm trying to find it.
Trying to find it. Maybe you gotta click hole first.
It's fine. Check it out. It's not fine. Maybe I'm too stressed.
You gotta yeehaw cowboy it over.
Arthur.
You gotta tie the rope to the lantern and swing it.
Now current plan is we're gonna go to this clock tower. I don't know about this one. It seems like it might be a bad idea. Oh, don't go worrying on me now, Blue Balls. We just gotta walk on in and make it our home.
That's right, Arthur.
We gotta go to Old Man Barrow's mansion and
I don't know about this one, Dutch. this clock tower seems to be kind of old and rickety.
Now, Marston. You just gotta have a little faith.
Here, Arthur, drink this.
It's gonna be okay, Arthur. I just need you to drink this.
Fucking, I'm stuck.
Just jump over it again.
All right.
Funny running jump. Bad end.
I'm gonna jump the hole, Dutch. Dutch, right, I'm too scared.
Oh, come on, Arthur. You just gotta have a little faith.
Look who's too scared to jump over the hole, eh, Dutch?
Shut up, Marcus.
Alright, let's try again.
Let's fucking go.
Maybe Bobby was kind enough to drop it down. Oh, I did. Here, I got it for you.
Damn, what do you do?
Am I stuck?
Let me look it up.
There couldn't have been a reason you can jump over.
Wait.
Now here's the thing. The only way you can get there now is by going up the rope.
Alright. That's fine. Fine by me. Is that a problem?
Don't know.
I guess Bobby could cut it.
Yeah.
Well, he's got to be quick.
Oh, shit.
Bless you.
Ooh. Thank you.
Just put the plate down.
Can I? Wait.
Maybe.
Wait.
A man can't climb with his garden shears, it's fine. He can't, actually.
Yeah, you just stab him in the wall.
Watch, Mr. Morgan! We can just put down the wooden plank here!
First floor can be seen.
That's a good thing,
it's fine. It's fine.
It's good. Robbie, you said Red Dead Online being its own thing now.
Yes.
I didn't say that.
Well, it is.
Oh, we were having a big conversation about that the other night.
No, Brian said that.
Oh, well.
Isn't like good $5. Brian.
It can't be.
Red Dead Online?
No.
Oh, maybe I don't know. thought that's what I heard.
I think on PS5, that's how, like, you're gonna be able to buy it separately.
Red Dead Online is getting a standalone release next week on PC and consoles.
Ooh. Do we have a
launches as a $5 standalone game.
Wow! That world for $5 is
now. Now go ahead and read the install size.
No.
For $5.
This isn't a biggest surprise, with both GTA Online and Red Dead Online having such. But the initial price, however, for a Rockstar game is pretty eyebrow raising. After February 15th of 2021, the price for Red Dead Online standalone will be raised to $20.
$20 is still fucking, like, just to walk around that world.
Right on. Will require up to 123 gigabytes of disk space. It says disk space. Too.
Oh, I hope whoever wrote that got fucking fired.
How dare they not take Red Dead seriously enough to say disk space instead of disk space?
You're gonna get called by the fucking Rockstar
the
CEO.
Option to purchase Red Dead 2 Redemption mode, Red Dead Redemption 2 story mode separately. This is a fucked up article. What am I reading? I'm going to PC Gamer instead. Hold on.
You got the info you needed.
$5 for that, for just walking into fucking Armadillo, is a 10 out of 10.
I'll buy that.
Right now, the team is focused on building on top of that world and providing as much scope for storytelling and in introducing a wide spectrum of different characters, all which can be experienced on your own or with a full posse of friends.
Posse.
When I played Red Dead Online, it was like right when it launched, so there wasn't like anything in it. So I'd be interested to explore that world again.
I hope that if I connect my Rockstar account to the standalone version, that my funny cowboy's still there.
I have to.
I want to see if Jebediah Furt made the transfer.
I'd have to assume that's original, why they do all that, right?
The origin of the Furt bloodline.
That's not the lore.
Jebediah. I like to think in my head that Jebediah Furt is the first. All right,
you're head cannoning.
Headcanoning for Furp. I like to think Jebediah Furp is the first Furp on American soil.
I had an idea on how Furp lineage works.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the idea is that, like, if Furp is in something, that it is connected to whatever a Furp is in another world.
No.
So, like, Furp Island from Tamagotchi Life.
Mm-hmm.
That exists within the same realm as Monster Hunter World, for example.
Mm-hmm.
I should open up Tamagotchi Life again and start that Twitter account back up.
That'd be funny.
Yeah.
I had this thing with Dark Souls and Demon Souls game where I always had a character named Barrett, but like Barrett was the surname.
Mm-hmm.
So every character was like Barrett the first, Barrett the second, the third, the fourth, and I think I'm now on the like Barrett the 27th because I started transitioning to other games with it.
Is there a Barrett the Stampede?
No. Hmm. I can now make that in Red Dead Online, though.
I made a character in Dark Souls 2 named Commanding Wife. Because I was really into that song. My Commanding
Wife.
She want to destroy
my life.
And like I did that as like a bit in a call, and then I just winded up like beating the whole game twice with that character.
My Commanding Wife.
My second playthrough of Dark Souls 3, I brought back my character from Dark Souls 2, but I didn't give her her name. I just called her the Swamp Wanderer because she was a pyromancer.
That there's a Swamp Wanderer.
Where do I? Where's the fucking mural room? Not the ceremony room. The mural room.
Map.
What?
The map help.
Oh, okay.
Oh, now I'm getting flipped. Okay. By that.
She want to
destroy my life.
I gotta look at that song, dude. with English subtitles. No, thank you. Turn those off.
Yeah, fuck that.
Chash, I got this cool song.
Thank you, High Windrose, for the tier 1 sub. Oh, yeah, Clock Tower is so good. Why isn't there a Clock Tower 2? I don't know. Good thing there isn't. Good thing nothing came out after this one.
Yep, no, the dead series. For character creation in, like, remasters or remakes of games, do you personally go and recreate the character you used, or you make another one, like a whole new character?
I can't think of an example.
I don't think I've ever done that, yeah.
I remade Furp when I, from Monster Hunter World from PS4 to PC.
Mm.
Do you have that mural room, by the way?
I'm looking on the map. That's the funny mannequin room.
Okay, good. They didn't laugh at me this time.
Wasn't it on the first floor of one of the main foyers?
You're right. It's, yeah. Okay.
I only bring that up because I keep referencing the Dark Souls and Demon's Souls, but I did that when Dark Souls 1 got remastered. Made Barrett, I think Barrett the fourth by that time.
With Dark Souls, with like Dark Souls and stuff like that, I've never really got attached to, like, at least when I played them, I never really got attached to like a specific character idea. But I feel like now, if I were to play those games, I would try my hardest to see if I could make like Dee Dee in them.
Mm-hmm.
Just because, like, that's all I got.
I feel like in Demon's Souls, you're probably good at doing that. Because with every other Dark Souls game, the character creation does not work.
It's right. Like, shit.
Where's the freaking, do I have the key even?
Epic room.
Nope. I have to go back upstairs.
Oh, my commanding wife.
Oh, she wants to destroy my life? Water.
My fucking goddamn commanding wife.
I was about to say, why am I so tired, but I know why.
Thanksgiving!
Thanksgiving! And I was up until 6 in the morning.
Why?
If only I knew. It's a mystery. Alright, now I got the key. Let's get the fuck out of here. Hi, Laura. Bye, Laura. iPhone. Oh my god, it's all fucking connected. It's all Tim Cook's fault.
Wow. You did it.
What do you mean you did it?
On the mural room.
Oh. I thought that there was some, like, tell.
Hold the demon idol with care. Tree in a forest, a person in a crowd. The idol is on a statue. Because on his statue's fucking nice pair of titties.
Hell yeah, dude.
Oh! In Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2, I made Robert Hombre.
You did? Yeah. Yeah, that was good. Okay.
I should get back in that game, man.
Yeah.
There's so much more to do.
There's more I should do in that game, but I'm like...
I'm waiting until they put Crash in.
There's Crash stuff.
I know what
I
said.
You can get a board that has concept art on it.
I know what I said. Yeah, does it have the Butch Hartman concept art?
No.
Damn.
Nod. They have women in this game, believe it or not.
Yo, they got girls here?
Alright, let's go get that Demon Idol.
Is it Demon Idol or Sceptor?
Gun build, because apparently every game I play I need to make things hard for myself. You can do a strength cannon build.
You could.
Or you
can be a weirdo.
They nerfed the fuck out of it, but...
Did they?
Yeah, I think it's like cannons can only hold like 2 shots now.
That's stupid.
Yeah.
What were you gonna ask a second ago, Jackson?
I don't remember.
It was about the idol that you were gonna get.
Oh, are you getting the Sceptor? Do you know if you need the Sceptor or the Idol?
The Idol. This is why I'm going over here right now.
I'm going over here to shove my hand down this woman's cleavage.
Ma'am, it's so I can escape, please.
Ma'am, I need this.
It's cold.
Pick up that Demon Lord.
All right.
Hey, women aren't real. Go back to bed. I can't. I have to stay up for the PlayStation 5 that I was promised to be by a woman.
Who promised you?
And you got scammed.
Woman.
Shut up.
The Craigslist one? Did you get scammed?
No, I didn't follow through with it.
Damn, that sounds like your fault.
It was a scam. It was an obvious scam.
Well then, what the fuck? What are you saying no for?
I thought you said it wasn't a scam. I thought you said it was legit.
I was until she was like, oh, when I was like, hey, I can come pick this up, da 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 da, and then she went, okay, sounds good, and then 30 minutes later without giving me the address, I went, oh wait, the advertisement is wrong. We live here. If you send us the money, we can ship it to you because my husband.
Oh, got it. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I'm like, and I was like, all right, have a good day. Delete, block your number.
Money order.
Is
it this? No.
Just want to be Spider-Man.
Remember to check your Monami pet? Oh, fuck, check it.
Hang on, let me go in my inventory. Shut up.
I gotta look at my pet!
Oh god, where is it?
Oh my god, gee.
Where is it? Oh fuck, dude.
Flick.
Woo! Can you just play Spider-Man on PS4?
I wanna be Miles.
I wanna
be
Miles
on PS4.
My PlayStation can no longer run new games.
Huh?
It's dying. I gotta clean it out. I've cleaned it out a couple times. If I clean it out again, maybe it can survive another year.
Is it a pro?
No.
That's probably why.
It is the first model PlayStation 4 that came out.
I wanna be Miles, but I also wanna be 60 frames per second Miles.
I want to be 12 frames per second.
Well, like 60
it.
Frames
well,
per second.
On the PC.
Maybe in our children's lifetime.
Yeah.
Maybe when Sony comes out with their own brand of computers.
There's Sony brand computers.
And Sony is like straight up. Like.
When they have their own OS.
Yeah.
When they have the PlayStation operating system.
God. The PlayStation. I've seen Yeah, play system. I've seen, like, I don't know. I don't know if this is a good idea or a bad idea or just like an out of the box idea. I've seen custom like PC sites now are like, hey, we put in the PlayStation 4 or the Xbox, whatever disk drive into the computer case. So you can just like switch your input on your monitor and put the disk into your computer.
That sounds useful. That sounds awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Why not? If you could load the OS on it.
Like straight up.
Let's go. Let's go kill the baby.
I also want to hate myself and replay Demon's Souls.
You got thrown in jail, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You get thrown
in game?
Jail. Yeah, in game.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Hashtag free dev. Free my boy dev, he did nothing wrong. What was that mean? What did you do?
Bought Haunted Ground.
Anyway, I gotta get escape from this baby.
Bought Haunted Ground.
Go, go, gadget bench extender.
I robbed somebody. Why are you here?
Bench bench.
I'm the bench bench. Oh, what are you looking left and right for? It's not a street.
Make sure there's a boat coming in or whatever.
Gets run over by a car. Go!
Jennifer, look out!
Yeah, Miss Mary comes in on the car. Bobby! yes, I do have rain noises on. In the background. For atmosphere.
We've killed Booby.
No, that's Dan.
Killed Dan. Buki.
We did it, folks. We killed Danny Buki. Now you can't play as him.
Finally.
Don't look at the leaks.
Hey, don't look at the leaks.
Not while
you're at work.
I looked at those leaks at a family function.
Of course you did.
I also looked at those leaks.
Yeah, floor two.
Now, please don't die.
What? We did everything. We did everything.
No, you didn't.
What okay. Run me through everything I'm supposed to do.
Okay. So I'm trying to get you to ending D.
Yeah.
It's like follow the directions for C, don't acknowledge the secret room, go to floor two in the elevator, and then da-da-da-da-da, the ending plays out. Then it's that for C. Follow the same directions as B. It's like floor two in the elevator, and then floor ending C was that big fight with Mary. So we already did that. This is a wholly different thing I'm trying to get you to do. Follow the directions for ending S or A, because it's like follow for B, but have Anna and Laura die. Follow the directions for S, but instead of going to the secret room, get thrown in the jail cell with Simon. Then play to the end. So you get thrown in the jail cell with Simon, play to the end, have Anna and Laura die, go to the second floor on the elevator. But don't go to the secret room.
And I'm supposed to get thrown in jail?
Mm-hmm. Which you did. You went into the jail cell with Simon, remember? Because we saw Laura die in the suit of armor, and then you were like, do I reset here? And I'm like, no, just walk out of the room and come back in.
All right. Well,
Mary threw you in jail.
Great job on the face graphic, everyone. Good job on helping.
What ending are we trying to get? D?
D. Trying to get ending D. And we're going to try to get ending E and then S.
Never enter the secret prison. Never enter the phone room. and never click on the shelf beside the calendar in the kitchen.
Oh no. Oh no. Wait. Don't go.
Then how do you get thrown in the jail? Now it's telling, that guide's telling you not to get thrown in the jail?
I'm looking at a different guide for de-ending. Do everything that you would for the S-ending, which I assume is just the same as the A. Except never enter the secret prison, never enter the phone room, and never click on the shelf besides the calendar in the kitchen. You find that you must enter the religious study if you get the scepter instead of the statue, then save just before entering the phone room. And if you trigger an event in that room, restart and keep entering the room until you do not trigger the event and get the key and leave.
I've been using this guide the entire time and the other endings have worked, but this one, this is stupid.
You can try to get the E ending instead. Which is doing everything for the D ending except going to a different floor.
So yeah, except I'm going to the third floor.
Okay, so...
Don't go to the prison now, I guess. Don't go to the phone room. Have the two schmucks die. Don't touch the shelf in the kitchen with the calendar.
Okay.
I could rewrite the guide for the S ending, but instead we're doing things for the D and E ending.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm gonna go watch On die.
It started when we were younger, you were mine, my boo.
Yo, yo.
She's frowning.
Fuck you. Twerp. Ow!
No.
Falls twerp. On the blade. Alright. Bobby has been averted.
Grace is averted.
Versus murdered. We did.
Alright, let's get the key. Hopefully it's here.
Yeah, follow S ending with statue, but never go to the secret prison, storage room, or phone room. Never examine shelf by calendar in the kitchen.
So when you say I'm assuming secret prison refers to the place where her father was.
Yeah, where their father is, yeah.
Well, this guide is telling me you need to do that. You have to go into the prison. You have to avoid the secret room. You have to.
Well, that's not a secret prison. That's a prison. That's a regular prison.
Yeah, I looked at three guides that said all the same thing. Don't go to the secret prison. Don't go to the storage room. And don't go to the phone room. Secret prison being the Simon room, which I guess we could just call it the Simon room for now on.
So don't go to the storage room?
This one says, yep, never go to the secret prison, storage room, or phone room.
Which I guess makes sense because you only need the perfume, the robe, and the idol to get down there.
Where
you don't
do I
really
get
need
the
him.
You don't need the rope at any point, do you?
I guess no, I suppose I don't. But where do I get the rope then?
Let's see.
I don't think you need to use it.
But I need to go downstairs, and I need to get past the dog.
To get past the dog, yeah.
Well, like, you if you put the board down, and then you have that other rope on the statue as well.
No. I mean, when I go into the when I go downstairs, I need both the robe and the perfume.
Mm-hmm. You get that from the closet room. Examine the leftmost box. Examine the rightmost box.
Okay, so that's not
examine
the
left
room.
Leftmost okay. box again for the black cloak. Okay. And then get past the sides.
Okay, that's not the. All right, so that's not the storage room. I thought that was the storage room. We're good then.
The storage room is where you get the rope, which you don't need.
But you get the rope from the what?
Because remember the rope is in. The rope is in that room that you have to climb over that shelf for, and you need to, or you can like push the box, and then behind that box is where the rope is.
Where the robe is.
Rope.
Oh no! Hang on! No, hang on.
There, cloak and rope.
Yes, but I thought that's just where you said that I need to be in order to get the cloak.
The cloak you get from the closet room.
Yeah, read that again to me. Read that part again to me.
Closet room. Examine the leftmost box. Examine the rightmost box. Examine the leftmost box again for the black cloak. Get pesticide from cans.
That's the same room where the rope is.
Storage room. Examine crates. Examine pipe. Enter hole.
Okay. Then that's the room that leads to the secret room with her father.
Got it. Don't go in there.
Okay.
Ooh. I thought that's what the storage room was. Yeah.
No secret room, no Simon room.
Okay. Alright. Got it.
I'm now looking up another guide because the one I've been using, I guess.
And
falls apart at those endings.
Phone room you don't go into.
No
phone in the phone room. Okay. Let me go upstairs. Shut up, phone.
Yeah, because
I was super confident that I would be able to, like, within the first like hour of this stream, get a new ending.
Because S ending with statue is living room, master bedroom, first bathroom, master bedroom, closet room, outside closet room, scream hall 2, child's room, library, plank hallway, storage room, secret prison, cage room, kitchen, phone room, chapel, caves, elevator. But in D ending, you don't go to the storage room, you don't go to the secret prison, and you don't go to the phone room.
Oh.
Which means I guess you don't need to go into the prison.
Mm-mm.
This is full of eggs and junk. Okay, so that's for the West Wing key. Alright.
Yeah, this is the room that I thought was the storage room. I'm sorry.
I thought it was too.
This is instead the closet room.
I'll forego the rope because, yeah, I don't really need it. Alright. So, alright, so I have, I guess, everything I need to just go into the West Wing.
I love when she speeds up just a little.
Well then, Dev, I'm sorry that we got two endings in a row because of this guide. That were the same thing.
It's all good.
It started when we were younger, you were mine.
I wonder how would I know if I need the demon idol or the scepter if I'm not supposed to go into the mural room?
Wait.
What do you mean the mural room?
You can go in the mural room. You can't go in the phone room.
Yeah.
But that's where the key is.
That's a location of the key, I believe, that can spawn in.
I've not seen it anywhere else then.
Or
let's see. If West Wing key is not obtained yet, examine bird's nest, then examine box, then examine bird's nest to get the key.
That's a different key. I need the silver key.
The silver key.
Let's see. Get key from toy box. Defeat enemy with panic button. That's in the child's room.
That's the ceremony key. Which I do need, so I will do that.
Cage room. Get key from table.
That's the... Okay.
kitchen. Use insecticides on meat locker to get key.
Oh, fucking yeah, duh. Stupid meat. Wait, no! That's the gold key.
Let's see. I'm just control effing key. Let's
That's fine. That's fair. Oh wait, actually, what I'm looking for, what do you upstairs?
Go to child's room and check the toy box for the chapel key.
Which is to open the room where you go down.
Yeah, that's the mural room you were talking about, right?
No.
The mural room is the one with the bookshelf that Dev has been pushing over for the scepter. Like, it's the one where she, like...
There's a room in the west wing... Or not in the west wing. In, like, the green wing, I'll call it.
Okay. So there's two different endings you can get. There's one that you get the staff and one that you get the statue. I can try to read the statue, which I think is a way to do it without knocking over the things to get the staff.
I don't want to be here yet. Well, the thing is that my understanding is that I need to get into that room to, like, pretty much trigger which one is I'm going to need to get. Because whether or not I can knock over the bookshelf or not determines whether or not I need to look for the scepter or the demon idol. Never again. I saw the lantern once and now never again. Alright, let me get the key from... Let me get the ceremony key at least.
Because, yeah, apparently you can go into the religious study and be fine. It does say follow S ending, the statue S ending, instead of the staff S ending, which is why I'm kind of iffy. Note, it is possible to do the following S ending with the staff, but the event in the phone room must not happen.
Oh, fuck.
We're trying to get D and E, though.
Yes. Both of these endings have that notation on it.
Okay.
As in, you can do... You can go into the phone room to get what you need, but the event in the phone room must not happen.
Mary can't show up.
Mary can't show up, yeah.
Okay, so got it.
We save state before we go into the phone room.
Okay.
I think you can also just, like, save in-game before you do that.
I don't think the... I think it, like, auto-saves before each room that you enter. We can test that out later. First, I gotta fuck this clown.
What?
Doll.
JKaddy3 says my brother bought me a computer and it's stuck at 33% on first boot up for 2 hours. I think I was in a similar situation.
They'll be like that.
Yeah.
Don't. Just leave it be.
Try 3 hours.
Just yeah, like to let it do its thing.
Yeah, try 3 hours.
Don't. All right, ceremony key. All right.
Started when we were younger, you were mine.
My boo.
Oh my god.
All right. Let me go to the kitchen.
To the window.
To the wall.
Bobby climbs down from the walls.
Oh shit.
Don't look at the fucking shelf. Stop. Okay. Almost instinctively picked up the ham.
Where we're going, we won't need ham.
Ham time.
Alright.
Ham time.
Ham time.
Ham time.
Dragon Quest time. Sorry. Chibon. He's going to tell my fucking mom.
My name, Ichi.
What? Go, fucking.
She's too scared.
All right, well.
We'll see.
Thank you, Jesus H.
She's too scared to move the camera to the left slightly.
I just won't. All right, so we're gonna. All right, so back out. Come out here. So I'm going to save a state, and here's what we're going to do. We're going to reset.
Okay.
I'm going to see if it's saved.
What's so humane about this talent?
Yes. Okay. It did save, but I did also save a state, so it's fine. All right. First try. Check it out.
The scene with Mary will not happen.
Wait. Where's the key? Where's the key?
You used the pesticide in the meat locker, right?
Is it on the first floor? I thought it was the one downstairs.
Yeah, no, it's on the first floor.
Oopsie. Okay, my bad. All right, well.
I don't think you ever got the key either.
No, I did. Cuz I you just take, get it when it you, you get that. You get it when you get the when you spray the insecticide. All right, check it out. First try. No problem. She's not going to show up. See?
No problem.
See?
Not even a fucking issue. Not
did
even
you see
a...
Laura die?
Nope. Do I need to? You know what? Not gonna. Here's what we'll do. Save. Save a state right there. Alright. We'll go upstairs.
Trying to do this in 1995 Japan.
Probably a guide.
To be fair, like, this is not the first release of Clock Tower 1.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Funny fucking mirror.
Hold the demon idol. Alright.
Thank God.
Alright, let's fucking go.
Fucking go, Jennifer. Did we talk about like schoolyard like rumors about video games last stream?
I don't think we did.
Because now that I'm thinking about it, there was a couple in my school that people were trying to spread around that were totally stupid.
Like what?
People were really, really, really dead set that that you could somehow in Kingdom Hearts 2 go to a Star Wars world.
Eh.
And there was one kid that was like, yeah, you get like a lightsaber keyblade, da da da. And we were like, no, we don't think so. And then we went over to his house and he showed us and we're like, this is Tron, you idiot.
That's funny.
These Star Wars. There's Luke. I'm like, no.
It's really funny.
That's not how that works. You crush that kid's hype? Good.
Good. He's an asshole.
He was wrong.
All right. Let's go. And if we fucking die in the elevator again, then I reload the save.
Reload the save. Look at Laura's funny face. Who did he think was Luke? The weird, like, Jeff Bridges character.
Yeah, whatever his name is. Peepo.
Whatever his name is. Yeah, Buka de Beppo. Also, a kid very determined that Metal Gear Solid 3 was an entire simulation. And that it was just Snake going through the memories of Big Boss. I'm like, no.
Wouldn't be that ridiculous, though.
Wouldn't be that far-fetched, but I'm like, no. You're just playing as this naked Snake.
What? What? It didn't...
Puppy!
He didn't growl at me!
What does it matter? Every game is a simulation? No, it's not. Video games are real. They're their own condensed universes.
You light video game lamps with electricity, real electricity, breathing manually, lactating, etc.
You are blinking manually, you are lactating manually, you are licking your lips. Orange Jennifer. You got the rope and the perfume. The robe and the perfume, Jesus. I mean, after MGS2 is not a wild theory. No, but...
Very specific.
Same kid who thought MGS3 was a simulation also thought that Destiny was just like gonna reveal Master Chief at some point.
Sure, fuck it.
And we were just like, no, they can't do that.
But what if? Lay down, Laura. You need the rest. You need the strength.
Need the rest of the legs. Because we keep pushing time forward. And we'll move forward now.
Hang on.
I'm hanging.
Okay.
Oh my God. This sped up version is like horrifying.
Oh shit, okay.
Did he eat you?
Too fast.
Bro, the baby got you.
Bro, the baby.
Was doing it too fast today. My inputs probably.
So you think you can mash.
Alright, let's try that again.
Run! Sounds like a RuneScape enemy.
It really does. Twin Peaks room? That's what I thought too when I first saw it. I was like, this is Twin Peaks. Mostly because of the
red.
The the curtain, yeah?
Before you, while you were gone, I was talking about how stupid kids in school had dumb video game rumors that were just nonsensical.
What was your favorite?
Not my favorite, just I think it's still the funniest to me is that I just said this, but a kid thought that the Tron world in Kingdom Hearts 2 was actually a Star Wars world. Cool. We had to explain to him how it wasn't.
And how you're wrong.
And how you are wrong, and then I had to
No, you're wrong.
I'm wrong? It's actually Star Wars?
Yeah, you just didn't know.
Show me Yoda. Show me Yoda in Kingdom Hearts with a keyblade.
Look at the mirror.
I remember the first time I was ever wrong.
All right, hang on.
Moment of truth.
What was the first moment you were wrong?
Wait, hang on. I need silence.
Okay.
I need silence. Am I cursed?
What
okay,
the
so
hell?
You okay? So reload that save state and figure out kill Laura.
All right.
Just knock it over.
Sorry, Laura.
So when were you wrong?
It's one of the first times I remember really being super wrong about something. I was talking to a kid about Super Smash Bros. Melee, and I was convinced that Luigi is not unlockable in that game. You can't get Luigi. And my friend was like, no, I unlocked Luigi. You can get Luigi in that game. I was like, no, that's just a fucking rumor. And he was like, oh, yeah, we'll try to do this thing and you can get him. I'm like, okay. And I went home and I unlocked Luigi. And I wanted to prove to him that he was actually lying. So I got the insert that you get in a guide that I had. And I tried to color it brown. Luigi's overalls brown. So I was like, no, look, it's just a Mario recolor. But I went into school that day and I was like, yeah, you were right. You can totally get Luigi.
Proud of you.
Yeah, no, it's a great story. It's a great story.
That says a lot about you.
It does. I was so ashamed. I was like, I can't believe you can actually get Luigi.
He had to do the walk of shame.
I know. He was like, did you get Luigi? I was like, yeah, I totally got
him. Yeah, I got Luigi.
Yeah, I got
We were still friends. He was just like, yeah, no, you can totally see. I told you.
At least he was cool about it, and he wasn't just like, idiot.
Yeah, no, we were still friends.
They were
friends. All right, let's, is this the... Nope. Yep. Wait, hang on. I actually didn't get the mural or the demon idol. Hold.
Demon idol.
If I get this ending one more time, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna be honest.
Break the cartridge in half.
We could just try to get the S ending.
Yeah, God. I think that's what I'll just do. I'll give up on the other endings and just go for the most complicated one.
An idol. That's called.
How many babies have we killed on these streams? Put up the counter.
Not enough.
You heard it here, folks.
Be the first to say it.
That thing's not a baby.
That's a dog.
It would be on a very specific pixel. All right, stupid dog.
Funny puppy.
Funny doggy.
Hello, doggy.
Baby!
You want to know the lore behind these cultists? It's not a cult, is one person.
One lady who gave birth to fucking demon babies?
Demon babos.
There's a prequel manga? Movie. Is that true?
Read it live.
Is there actually a prequel manga to this? I'd read it.
Holy heck.
Dated.
Blood. I just killed a child.
Excellent work, Jennifer. That's why you're the survivor. All right. What more do you want from me?
Like,
it'll work.
Second floor.
Please. Please. Please.
Too long.
Please. What do you want from me? What do you want from me? What? What?
Let me just read this.
Oh.
Reset the cartridge.
Maybe you really can never enter the phone room.
But that's impossible, because I need the key that's in there. Because then how... Because otherwise there's no way to know whether or not I need the scepter or the demon idol. Just look up like the ending on YouTube? Yeah, fuck it. Why not?
That's what I did for Layers of Fear, because my game bugged out and I couldn't get the map.
Maybe my game bugged out. Maybe my game is progressively getting worse.
Let's go for the S ending.
Yeah, let's just do the S ending.
Yes.
Let's get a new ending tonight.
Because I, the guide I'm looking at has just like, it looks like you know what to do now. So like the guide I'm looking at just has steps and what to do. It is also a non-spoiler guide.
Great.
So it doesn't tell you, like, and then watch this cutscene where this happens. I'm also going to post this in here just so Jackson also has it. It's also on GameFAQs.
Click. This is the one I'm looking at right now.
Cool.
Ending duh. Or no, we're doing ending uth.
We're doing s. Because the thing about the D and the E ending is that you do the exact same things in them, just depending on what floor you ultimately go to is what determines the ending.
All
Are
right.
you ready? You sound tired.
Yeah, I am.
How long have we been streaming? It's been 2 hours, right?
Been about almost 2.5.
It's been 2 hours and 25 minutes. Also, I will reiterate, I was up until 6 in the morning.
That's after you wake up.
Fuck you, that's why. I woke up maybe around like 10 or 11.
First step. The living room. Examine the box in the living room.
Box?
What it says right here.
I'm assuming the living room is the next room over. I hope. Fuck you.
Shh.
Alright. Keep it down out there. I'm trying to get a true ending.
Wow.
Look at my guide.
All right.
Box. Empty.
Got it.
Cool.
Ready to start over?
Master bedroom.
To the master bedroom.
Okay.
Examine picture for minor plot development. Get perfume from dresser. Do not examine parrot.
Do not examine that.
The parrot's gotta live. What is this? Are these the fucked up babies?
These are the fucked up babies. These are the fucking fucked up dumb babies.
Alright, get the perfume. Alright, now what?
First bathroom.
Alright. Sorry, Laura.
Keep Sorry. The door open.
Yep.
Check shower for scene.
Sorry, Laura, your death is needed for progression. I mean...
are you doing the one with staff or statue?
I'm doing the one with... we can do the one with statue if you want to.
I'll do the statue one when we figure out which one we need.
Okay.
Alright, I gotta juke this guy real quick.
Well, if you wanted to, you can go to the closet room. Because that's the next place we gotta go.
Okay.
The closet room.
And away we go. That's upstairs?
Do you like that noise? It's the noise Dev's game is making.
How long was he in that bathtub? It don't matter.
Oh, wait. Go. Come on. Yes!
Closet room!
We're in the closet room.
Examine the leftmost box to climb over.
Hang
you already
on.
Did that. You already climbed over.
Well, she's not gonna check on her way out. Eh? Okay.
Examine leftmost box.
I got it. You did it once already, Jennifer. Come on. Just because the adrenaline's gone doesn't mean... So examine rightmost box?
Left.
I did that.
Examine leftmost box to climb over. So I assume push the box.
Okay.
Now okay. Examine the leftmost box.
Okay, get the black robe. Okay.
Examine the rightmost box.
What's in here? Nothing else.
Examine the leftmost box again for black cloak. Get best aside from cans.
Okay. Okay, I'm assuming that box I pushed was the rightmost.
Yeah.
In their eyes, even though that's technically not true, but it's fine.
Outside of the closet room, if West Wing key has not been obtained yet, examine bird's nest.
Alright.
Bird time.
Alright, bird time. Looks like a bird's nest.
Examine the box. Examine the bird's nest. Now go to the kitchen.
Alright, let's go spray some bugs.
Doing it well.
Kitchen, use insecticide on meat locker to get key. Do not examine refrigerator.
Yep. Fuck that ham. Don't need it.
Scream hallway 1 or 2. Do not examine windows if event occurs. Because we're going to be going to the child's room next.
Oh, damn, okay.
Oh, damn.
All right,
oh,
so we're
this is already diverging from the statue run.
Alright, so we are going... We're going to the West Wing, then. So just keep going no matter what happens?
Yep. Do not examine windows if event occurs.
Okay. Event did not occur?
Great.
Alright, so we're going to the child room.
Yep, because we're going to be getting a key from the toy chest.
Alright. I'm just going to do nothing more than what you're telling me to do right now.
Okay, I understand what they mean by secret fucking prison now.
What?
Your papa's room.
That's what I've been saying!
Yes, yes.
Why the fuck did this guy call the Simon Room the secret prison?
I was calling it that because I got the names mixed up.
I hate gamers in the early 90s.
I've been saying the whole time that the secret prison, because it's secret. The shed isn't a secret.
I know. That's why I'm reading these now and being like, yeah, you were right. I'm not saying you were wrong. I'm validating you.
You got it.
All right. So I think the child room is this one.
You're the one playing the game. I'm just sitting here with my thumbs in my ass.
Yes. All right. Let's get the ceremony key.
Get the key for toy chest and defeat the enemy with the panic button.
Let Dev glow. I will always let Dev glow.
All right. Come on. Think you're better than me? Bitch.
I'm better.
Alright. Now what?
Plank hallway!
Plank hallway!
Examine hole, then examine the plank.
Examine hallway, then examine plank!
Storage room!
Alright, we're gonna see Peepaw. Well, first we gotta... First, we gotta fucking own Bobby.
Examine crates, examine pipe, enter hole.
Unless. Hang on, I should probably hang back just in case. Nope, no, Jennifer, no. No, God, oh, God. Back up. Yeah.
In case of event, go back through plank hallway.
Oh!
Meow.
It was just a cat.
We did it.
Please just be a cat.
Meow.
It turns into Bobby.
I was thinking maybe he's just still in the box and then he just like comes up. Alright, thank you. Does that mean Bobby can also be in the other bathroom?
Yes.
Holy shit, dude!
Bro. Parker's trying to sell me Lego Flintstones.
Enter collapsed hallway.
Alright. Peepaw.
War.
It's my dad.
You are my dad.
Alright,
examine everything! The far right thing last. Watch long scene.
Alright. Last thing last. Looks like someone was counting days. Marks are cut into this wall. It looks like a chart of some sort. Mary's and patients' names. The name of the master of the house.
Ryan Riddles.
Mary Bill. Barrows.
Bill Collins.
Bill Collins is up next.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're 30 and up and white, you like Bill Collins.
Looks like a chat. The patients were two newborn babies. That's it. A black medical bag. A name's embroidered here. Walter Simpson. Walter Simpson? I gotta be honest, every single time someone in chat asks if we've gotten a new ending yet, my heart kind of sinks a little. No.
We're about to.
No, chat, we haven't. All right. All right. Look at Peepaw.
Look at dumb shit. You died in a room, idiot. Die outside like the rest of us.
Looks like a Mimo.
Finding Mimo.
We are now watching Log Scene.
November 10th, 1986. This is the third day. I, Dr. Walter Simpson, have been in here. I'll not last long. Before I die, I will record this. There were twin children who are blemished on this world. When the lady was to give birth, I was called to this house. As she gave birth to a new child, no demons. When they were born, they ate my right hand. They were there. Their bodies deformed. They should have died, but they lived. I should have tried to. Breathing is painful. The air in this room is already gone. They are in a cradle under the star. Jennifer, Jennifer, Jennifer.
I can feel it.
Coming in the air tonight. All right.
Cage room! The interchangeable room.
Cage room?
Use cage key from table and use cage key on cages.
All right, got it. Cage room is downstairs. Fuck, I don't remember where the cage room is. Is it this one? I think it's this room right here.
Save before going in.
Yes. Yes!
Cool.
I'm a genius.
You did it.
That's okay, guys. Chill. Alright, so get the cage key. Use cage key, right?
Cage room, interchangeable room. Get cage key from table. Use cage key on cages.
All right. All right, I've used the cage key on the cages.
Phone room! Changes places with the religious study. Keep leaving and entering until seen. Leave. Re-enter. Get key from table.
Hang on. Oh, I assume that means it's going to be the scene where Miss Mary tries to kill you. Oh, yeah, because now you know the truth. Okay. Keep going.
Don't look outside.
Okay, so... Alright, so now I want to go in the phone room. Yes?
Cage room and then phone room.
I'm gonna...
Change his place with religious study.
Change his place with... Get up. So what am I supposed to do?
Keep leaving and re-entering until seen.
Okay.
Leave, re-enter, get key from table.
Okay, so I want to get fucking attempted at by Miss Mary. Shit. I was hiding inside the night suit, Jennifer.
I was hiding.
Fucking get out here, hag.
All right.
Thank you. Miss... Mary.
Glad to see you safe, Jennifer.
I don't think you're being truthful when you say that.
Is there something wrong? Come here.
Get the fuck out of there.
Bye, bitch.
Re-enter.
Bye, bitch.
Get key from the table.
All right. Get the silver key.
Music room.
Never mind. Go to the music. Back to the music room. Music room is.
Save state before you enter the music room.
Yeah, of course. If I remember where it is. I'm just gonna... That's the... Nope, that's the ceremony room. I remember. I'm gonna guess it's the room right next to the rat room. And guess what? I'm a genius. All right.
Music room. Interchangeable room. Examine curtain and find either staff or event. If event, then switch to S ending with statue.
All right.
All right. All right, folks. Moment of truth. Is it staff or is it staff?
Hooray! Religious study!
All right.
Religion time. My work here is done.
So far, what have we done from the ending differently from the endings that we were trying to get before?
Different orders, it seems. Like
when it's a funny fucking secret room and shit.
Yeah.
We also have not we also have not looked at any deaths.
No, we haven't actually.
So I maybe we did. We looked at Laura.
We did.
Yes, I think
Laura.
I think
Laura's the only death we've seen.
Mm.
So maybe An was just fine actually. All right.
Religious study. Examine bookshelf.
Which one?
Examine bookshelves.
Okay, both of them. Both of them. It has chemical symbols on it. This is hard to understand. Dot, dot, dot.
Examine painting.
Mural covers the entire wall. Part of it's hidden behind the shelf.
Examine everything on and around the desk.
There's a note here. Time will cause adherence. Clock tower's clock stopped. Alright, various chemicals are on the desk.
Examine left bookshelf.
Wait, hang on. Alright. Examine left bookshelf. Alright. Push.
Examine painting. Then use staff on right side of painting.
Fix a ceremony. Is that room inside this house? Staff on right side of painting? What? Dot, dot, dot.
Jennifer may say nothing, but it may not affect anything.
Okay.
Chapel!
I'm assuming that's the ceremony room. Alright, let's go, boys.
And the plank's already there.
Well, I did that.
Alright.
Alright, chapel.
Chapel! Examine everything for minor plot development.
Sure, why not? Looks like the one in the mural. This is a crow corpse. The neck's completely severed. Dot, dot. Strange symbols are written here. Time will cause adherence. What does that mean?
Make sure to examine star pattern on floor.
Okay, good thing I'm doing that. Square hole is visible. The cradle under the star. There's something underneath.
Examine flower vase, then use staff on it.
Hang on, hold on. There's an iron disc. A cross has been carved into it. Alright, so use... I'm just going to look at the flower vase first. This is a celadon vase. Alright, so use staff on vase.
Yes.
Alright, click. What was that sound? What was that noise? Okay.
Caves!
Caves!
Go right and use black cloak and perfume on Jennifer.
What's up, Miss Mary? Yeah, I can see that.
Dog. Fucking puppy.
Alright, dog knows the smell very well. Smells like the perfume Mary uses. Alright. Okay. What next?
Go all the way right for event.
Alright, we gotta see Lot. Or something. An event. It could be different now. I have no idea.
It's Phil Collins.
Phil Collins is up next. I can feel it calling in the caves tonight. Oh, Lord.
Oh, my God.
It's totally Lot. Lot, you're still alive?
Jennifer. Switches.
In Best Buy.
In the clock tower. They're just lights. They're not the original.
Lot?
Don't leave me alone. Okay.
Then back to the left and go through door in background.
Going through door in background.
Don't go too far.
Or you'll get mauled. That's okay, I'm still smelly. Alright.
Then keep going right until event.
Until baby.
Kill that kid.
Why am I, like, calm now after seeing Lot?
Because you know what you're doing.
Why do I feel like I've done this before?
Alright. Keep going right until event?
Yep, keep going right until event.
What happens if I go here? Okay.
No. What if we never, like, check there and there was just, like, something super secret there?
Does it say to interact with something?
Like the says, go all the way right for event, then back to left and go through door and background. Keep going right until event, panic button presses occur. Go through door and background.
That sounds new. Alright, so yeah, so go right until event, which I'm assuming means baby.
Babu.
At which point we go to the left.
Panic button presses occur. Go through door and background.
Alright, and from that point on, it's just from that reading, it sounds like things are new.
And then we go to elevator.
Yeah. Like I said, from that point it sounds new, so we'll see. Alright. Goodbye, Dan. Hopefully for the last time.
Until we do the DM.
Alright, so go through the door in the back. Alright. Let's see. Keep going right until...
Elevator.
Elevator. And then what?
Examine button on wall.
Please, God. Please, God. Please.
Go to third floor.
Safe state. What fucking emote is that? You live! Mm.
And you live!
Huh. Why do I feel like I'm supposed to see Bobby show up there, right? Like.
Graphical error.
Maybe. Okay. Here we go. New ending time.
Hopefully.
Hopefully, new ending time. All right. All right, buddy. Oh, wait. There's on.
Whew. Whew. Well, glad that's over. On!
You killed my sons!
And the crows!
Oh, get fucked.
Get you fucked, Benny. Who was that?
That's the ham.
It's Monokuma.
Hello! This gives me an idea.
All right, and then Aunt's gonna try to kill me. Not gonna talk about it.
No.
Not gonna talk about what just happened.
No.
Is that it?
And there's a variation to this ending depending on who you see die first.
Oh, that's fun.
So it's either or.
That's funny.
And then I think in the second game it's confirmed that it's just on.
Okay.
Because the staff.
So you got out of there saving at least one person.
Yeah.
That's the canon ending.
That is the best possible ending you can get.
You did it. You did the most complex ending.
That was the most complex. Oh.
It's gonna be like S1, S2 now in the list. We got a new ending. We got the most complicated ending. We did it.
So now if someone comes to the chat and they ask if we got an ending, you're damn right we did.
We did.
Thanks, Koichi Tawara.
Hey.
Thanks, Koichi. Oh shit, Moobot isn't subscribed anymore. Fuck.
Ah, fuck. That is worth an unstreamer, though. You're absolutely right.
Thank you, though.
That for Haunted Grounds, right? Yeah, boot it up.
No, that's for Chase.
Oh yeah. You know, we went offline and Chase was talking about how they were so excited to play Haunted Ground.
Yeah. Chase like couldn't shut up about it. He was like, fuck this Danganronpa shit. I hate it.
He was thinking about ending Danganronpa like right there and just wanted to jump right into Haunted Ground.
He's really interested in the dog aspect of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that.
Y'all hear that?
Sorry. I got gas in there.
You're not gonna finish your pulp work?
My tummy hurts because I was so nervous it's my Romeo.
Does your tummy still hurt?
Yeah.
Take another bite of the pulp work. Not all eat.
My puppy.
Ana's alive in the sequel, he could be wrong. I remember in the sequel game that Ana is there. I read something where it's like, yeah, it's canon that Laura dies because fucking Twin Peaks, blah, blah, blah.
Who killed Arnold Palmer?
Who killed Leland Palmer?
Who drank Arnold Palmer?
317 Palmer.
Just pushes her off the top of the tower.
We're really just not going to talk about any of it. Nothing. Nothing about what just happened. How did you even get here?
Yep.
I heard you fall into the pool.
I'm telling you. Schrodinger's cat.
Well,
we did see the cat. You're right. This is a visual novel, I guess. No? Yeah, yeah. all right. Well,
let's go for that D ending, though.
Sure.
Do you actually want to?
Do you actually want to go for the D ending?
Are you feeling confident about this guide?
Well, I got an ending. I got an ending from it.
So, if it makes you feel better, if you go for ending D, you could just press continue and then get ending E.
If I get ending D.
If you get ending D, you go to the elevator and you're not chopped up. Then when you hit continue, you should be in front of the elevator and then you can get a different ending.
Okay. All right. So how are we doing ending D?
We're going to do everything that we did in S, but we're not going to go to those rooms that we mentioned, which are the secret prison, the storage room, or the phone room.
Okay. All right.
So we'll be following the with statue ending, which is slightly different, but you're going to be doing a lot of the same things at the beginning, including going to the living room and examining the box.
All right. Living room. Thank you for the anonymous gifter for gifting Moobot a tier 1 sub.
Thank you.
I'm really glad people are keeping that going.
Gonna need an unstreamer on that.
Yeah. All right. Living room. Thank you, Cube. Quick on the draw. All right. Examine the box!
Examine the box!
Key, yes. Okay.
Nice.
All right, let's go.
Master bedroom.
Master Chief.
Check this out.
Yeah, what?
Examine parrot!
All right. Bird, bad news. Don't post Dropity Cheap in response to this. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. All right, bird has been examined.
Examine right bed.
Kill you.
Get perfume from dresser. First bathroom. Keep door open and check shower for scene.
Keep door open. Well, I can't really control that. Chuck shower.
Can you lock the door?
You rock the Casbah.
Laura?
It says master bedroom, examine left bed. But I assume that's so you can get away from Scissor Man.
Yeah.
El Scissor Man.
So master bedroom, examine left bed!
El Sizzler.
Did you hear that?
Yeah. Oh, poor me.
Neff says poor me.
Oh my god.
Why don't we hide under the bed with the bird?
You want to squish the bird?
It's a cool animation.
Oh, he's just leaving. Yeah, I really like that, like, whoosh, like, scissor cut. Okay. Cool.
Closet room!
Meow! Hang on.
Examine leftmost box, examine rightmost box, examine leftmost box again for black cloak, get pesticide from cans.
I'd really consider it the middlemost box. I think they should edit that guide.
Yeah, furry Shep, you should edit this guide. Outside closet room, if West Wing key has not been obtained yet, examine bird's nest, then examine box, then examine bird's nest key. Scream Hall 2, do not examine windows if event occurs, because we're going to be going to the child's room!
So don't go to the kitchen.
Not yet.
Okay. Don't go to the kitchen, go to the chapel. Don't go to the kitchen, go to the chapel.
Child's room!
Go to the child's room. Ignore the screaming, go to the red hall. alright.
Don't stop a bang bang, the boogie jumped up.
I'll be honest, I kind of expected more out of that ending.
Maybe you'll get something from the D ending.
Maybe.
I think the fact that somebody lived is pretty spectacular.
I know. I mean, this is a relatively simple game, so I guess I feel like I expected more, like, development or something.
You wanted Anne to turn into a baby.
I feel like you could have afforded that better.
Dan baby.
Dan Bambino.
Dan Bambino.
Dan Bambino.
Dan Bambino. Defeat the enemy with the panic buttons.
Kill the enemy. Oh.
All right. Now.
Library.
Oh, where's the library? Safe state. Where's the fucking library? Is it right here? I think it's right here. No.
I would load state.
Yeah, sure.
Library.
That's not the library. That's not the library either.
Load state! Library!
I think it's downstairs. That's not the library either. That's the fucking doll room. It is this room. Boom, it's that easy.
Examine second from left bookcase. If there's no book mentioning the statue, then switch to ending S with staff.
Okay.
So, was there a book mentioning a statue?
Various technical books, no.
So there was no book mentioning the statue?
No.
If there's no book mentioning the statue, then switch to ending S with staff. So we're getting the staff.
Okay.
Plank hallway. Examine hole, then examine plank.
Wait, so then I'm going back up and doing the... Wait. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, right. Wait.
Yeah, I don't want to go in there, I thought, though.
Says... library, interchangeable room. examine second from left bookcase. There's no book mentioning the statue, and switch to ending S with staff. So if that's the case, then after the child's room, you would have went to the plank hallway to put down the plank there. And then we would go to the storage room and the secret prison, which we're not going to. So that means we are going to the cage room.
Cage room it is.
Oh, wait, well, we need to get the, we need to get the staff. That's right. Where's the staff again?
Music room.
That's in the music room. Okay, so we're on the right track here.
So can I just get the staff then?
No, you're going to want to release the animals from the cage.
You would release the animal.
Which room is it? Is it this one? Nope. Oh, man, I'm fucking up.
But now we know that we need the staff without going to the phone room.
Here, 1 second. I gotta loop back around. Okay. Okay, so I want to go to the
cage room,
which is nope. Where is the cage room? Is it upstairs? So I guess it's upstairs. I think it's this one. Watch me right. Yeah.
Nice.
Alright, get the cage key.
This geeky rat.
What if there was an ending where you go into the cage room, then you don't free the animals? But then they still get freed anyway, and then they kill you. Because they're like, why didn't you help me, bitch? I'll kill you.
Why didn't you help me?
Why did you drink all my milk? All right. Where to now?
Cage room. We are not going to the phone room. We are going to the music room.
Okay. Safe state real here. I believe this is the music room. Alright, investigate.
Music room. Examine curtain and find either staff or event. If event, then switch to S ending.
Mm-hmm.
With statue. So I assume that this will be there will be a staff here.
Yeah, because he just popped out from the ceiling. So he's not going to be behind the curtain unless he fucking teleports. Okay.
Nice! So that's how you figure out how to do that without the phone room.
Oh, God, I don't care about you. All right.
Religious study!
That's... okay. That's not the chapel.
Chapel's after the religious study.
Yeah. Okay, so I want to go upstairs. Wait. Don't I need to, so I don't go in the phone room?
Do not go in the phone room.
Will that door just be unlocked then?
For the religious study?
Yeah, because I need a key to go in here, don't I? Yeah. Unless the staff compels it to open.
What's that key you have?
The cage key?
Let's see. Don't go to phone room. Let's see.
Is there another way to get the silver key?
At this point, I think we can go into the phone room, but we have to make sure that the event doesn't happen.
Okay.
So save state we.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think this is the point where we can go into the phone room. So yeah, it is possible to do following S ending with staff, but event in phone room must not happen.
Okay. All right, check it out. Frame perfect. No Mary. I need to get the key first from the kitchen.
But don't get the ham.
Don't get the ham. No ham. What if Bobby was just in there?
You hit him with insecticide?
Alright. Check it out. No Miss Mary. Frame one. Not even worried about it. Not even worried about it.
Nice.
See? Yeah. No Miss Mary. Nice. Not even worried about it. I'm gonna not look at Laura.
Don't.
Aura on.
Guy doesn't say to do that, so. Scary.
Alright. Go to the religious study. Woo! Alright.
Examine bookshelves, examine painting, examine everything on and around the desk, examine left bookshelf, and examine painting, then use staff on right side of painting. Jennifer may say nothing, but it might not affect anything.
Now, chapel?
Chapel!
Alright, folks.
Alright, gamer.
Examine everything for minor plot development. Make sure to examine star pattern on the floor. Examine flower base, then use staff on it. If it doesn't work, examine floor and painting and religious study again.
Why does she not care about the...
painting?
Yeah, she doesn't care about the star.
Top left.
Hmm.
Another vase?
Thought you said to investigate the star pattern.
Just said make sure to do that.
Okay.
Examine everything from minor plot development. Make sure to examine pattern on floor. Examine flower vase and use staff on it. If it doesn't work, examine floor and painting and religious study again. So you gotta go to the religious study again.
Fucking A.
Oh shit, I forgot to look at something in the religious study.
Oh fuck, I left the sink on. Okay. That room's somewhere in this house. Yep. Damn, you're right, Jennifer. Why do you not care?
Bitch care.
There we go.
Okay.
All right.
Caves! Go right, use black cloak and perfume on Jennifer, go all the way right for event, then back to the left and go through door and background. Keep going right until the panic button presses occur. Go through door and background.
Yeah, okay, Miss Mary.
So we're going to be going to the right to see Lot dead as well.
Clip this entire stream? I think that's just called a VOD. Alright. Hey, Lot. Die. Using my psionic energy to make Lot die faster?
Killer dead.
Hospitalizing myself by inflicting negative thoughts.
Continue as normal, and if we're able to get into the elevator, we are going to be going to the third floor.
Oh, we're doing that ending?
You have to get E before you get D.
You gotta walk before you run.
I can't believe Jennifer is one of Joe's psionic warriors.
We are sealing a boo-boo bear within the earth, technically.
We are doing that.
Let me just rest up real quick.
4J and David Lynch copy pasta, but it's with a lot.
Stealing, yeah, that's what I was.
Equipment.
Yeah, hospitalizing myself. inflicting negative thoughts. Alright. Alright, Dan.
And this time?
Alright, Dan Bambino, it's fucking over.
Hey! Jennifer! I got Star Wars and. They got the slave one on sale at Target.
Boba Fett slave one.
They got Super Mario 64 Shindo edition on sale here.
vintage Gundams.
Shit, dude, they got Legos.
Vintage Dragon Balls.
Yu-Gi-Oh.
They
got Yu Yu Hakusho here.
They got Bleach.
Yo, Dragon Ball and some other anime.
Uh-huh.
What are
you
talking about?
What's this voice you're doing?
Cool voice. Cool new character.
cool new character in Word Shopping. What do you think?
Yo, they got Toriko.
Yo, they got ColecoVision.
Alright, so.
They got the Turbo Graphics.
They got the piss engine.
So theoretically, you should go into that elevator and have an option to go to
third floor.
Floor you want.
Third okay. floor.
All right, let's see.
And it'll just work.
It'll just work. Frame one.
It should work. Work.
This game sucks.
Oh!
The pause. The pause just scares
third.
Me.
Third floor. Third floor.
Third floor. Third floor. Yeah. It's time to vent.
Oh my god.
I wonder what changes because we didn't see our dad. Shut up, dude. We didn't see our dad and we didn't. Oh, there he is!
You get it. This is the changed ending.
So I was, okay, so before I was like, here.
That's why I was like, not saying anything.
How come you don't see Bobby in the elevator? Oh, that's fun.
Graphical error.
Ah, you little sneaky little son of a bitch, you.
Graphical error.
Now, we can get the other ending by hopefully just hitting continue.
Hit continue and go to the second floor.
And go to the second floor.
Damn.
No, Dan. And Bobby. Yay!
Because
you're all the characters in this game.
Friends sucks.
What's your least favorite thing about Friends?
I don't know. I hate the characterization of all of them. They just seem obnoxious.
That they're all friends.
Everybody talking shit about friends.
I wish they were enemies instead.
Like, there's some good aspects to that show, but like, I sit down and I try to watch it because everyone's like, well, Friends is a good fucking show. I'm like, okay.
Everybody's talking shit about Friends.
Everybody talking shit about Friends.
It's just obnoxious character writing. It's like, it's just the TV at the time. Like, I can watch The Nanny because Fran Drescher is just hot. That's okay. It.
Got it. Fair. Go ahead. Yeah. Okay.
That's it. All the characters in that show are also stupid, obnoxious. But like,
that's why I watch Full House. I mean, I just watch it for Uncle Jesse.
Hey, I wanted to be Uncle Jesse when I was growing up.
And look at you now.
Yeah, David. Look at me now.
David, you saying you straight? Okay.
Look at me now. Now I'm a misogynist with good hair. I got twins. I got a hot wife who committed fraud for a college.
Remember that episode?
Remember that episode where Aunt Becky goes to prison?
All right.
Now you're going to hit continue.
Well, first, actually, before I click continue.
Feels good. Feels good.
Sabekuzefju.
All right, let's go. The last Clock Tower ending.
The last Clock Tower stream.
Two.
Everybody talk shit about Friends.
Consider the game to remind you you're human every time you start it. Yeah, despite everything.
You still you.
Is he gonna be at the end of this hallway? Oh. Who? Miss Mary.
No shit. Good to see you, Jennifer. You're safe now.
Mary!
Oh, she doesn't know.
Oh! Why?
Talk shit about Friends, will you?
Oh, shit, the turn?
There are plenty of black people in Friends, Jennifer. All you have to do is watch the show.
Name one, Miss Mary.
I got a whole song. Everybody talking shit about my friend.
That was that.
Damn. Alright, so both of those endings are just different ways that Jennifer just gets gunched.
Yeah.
Gunched. I wanna see that ending list screen.
Oh no, you will. We will.
It does like a funny like shine sheen now.
Oh yeah, actually, it doesn't.
If you do it without dying to Bobby once, you get a star on your profile.
Oh.
We beat Friends, everyone. Well,
I'm looking up pictures of Fran Dresser.
Can you wait until after the stream at least?
No, I'll mute. Don't worry.
God, I hate you so much.
And I'm looking up that Talk Future song.
And I'm.
What?
I don't know.
Oh. you wanted to be involved in that?
You know the old fucking Gurr bit from Mayor Zim?
No.
We're like.
And I'm.
Zim's like, I'm gonna da 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 da. And Zim's like, I'm gonna da 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 da. And Gurr goes like, and I'm. I don't know.
Why is Mother 3 trending? Robbie, did you do this?
Why is what?
Why is Mother 3 trending?
Oh, yeah, because I fooled everyone on Twitter again.
Yeah.
Persona 3 is trending for me.
Everybody remembered the robot?
God, I remember the robot. Which robot?
What the fuck does that mean?
Which robot from Persona?
Persona 3!
Yeah, which one?
What?
There's more than one!
Robot?
Yes!
What?
Oh my god.
What do you mean, oh my god? I thought it was just Aegis! Oh, now you clam up.
I'm looking up a picture. I'm
trying to see where your mother.
Oh, is it the one? Is it the one in fucking the fighting game too?
Yeah.
Okay, never mind. All Labyrinth. Right. Labyrinth. All right, fine. I seen that one. Whatever. All right, human entertainment. Entertainment for humans.
I want to see that ending list.
And you will.
Ending Z pops up.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah! That feels good.
Ah. Feels good.
And all it took were four parts.
Four parts. Like around. You know what? You know what? We did it in like 12 hours. Don't count them.
That's a video game. That's a quick video game.
That's a video game.
That's a video game to play over the weekend if you rented it from a Blockbuster.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
Like, we all just like stayed up for 2 days straight and just ran through it.
Went over to Dev's house for the weekend, sat on the couch, and played Clock Tower together.
That's, well, you know what? Mm-hmm. Guys, we did it. We beat Clock Tower. Actually, I'm just going to go back on the ending list. We beat Clock Tower, and I think the rain's clearing up.
Oh, would you? Oh, wow. Look at that. I didn't look at the
rain. Guys.
The rain stopped.
Oh. You know what? I realized something.
What's that?
The clock tower was the friend we made along the way.
I'm really glad that we could beat Clock Tower and beat the clock tower along the way. And, you know, the rain stopping is also good because we have been getting floods for the past, month.
Yeah.
It's
been getting real bad. So I'm glad that it's, I'm glad that it stopped. So you know what?
I got puddles in my shoes.
Before we go, I think I'm just gonna turn the lights on real quick.
Yeah, it's flick them on. Why not?
Flick them on. Oh. Oh, you should have warned me. Ah.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Oh, that's better.
Should warn me. Oh,
yeah,
God.
It's really bright.
It's really bright. You had the lights off for like 2 days straight, dude. Come on.
Really, really bright in here.
Close the curtains.
Sorry. I'm really sorry.
Close the curtains. Ugh.
I didn't mean to. All right. I'm gonna go to BRB. And you know what? In real time, I'm gonna set everything back. click.
Oh. Uh-oh.
There we go. All right, let's go to Twitter.
What happened there?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
We're gonna look at art.
Chad, if you drew anything for tonight's stream, be sure to post it. On Twitter.
Hang on, first things first. I need to let my cat in. First things first.
If you made any art for tonight's stream,
mm-hmm.
Sure to post it on Twitter with the hashtag OkieDokieArt. If you got a Twitter.com, if you don't got a Twitter, send it to my email, Robbie@Robbie.zone.
What music should I play?
Virginity is cool loop.
Virginia's
no.
cool
Jackson,
MIDI.
What music should I play?
Virginia's cool MIDI.
Okay. Can't trust either of you.
Do the Mega Man X soundtrack. Whatever.
Sure.
Do Runtilda's lair for the last spooky stream.
Sure. Runtilda's lair.
Made any art? You made art.
You made any art? You drew. Congratulations.
Congrats.
Right. Let me do one more refresh of the thing before I go to the overlay. To go out of my brain just immediately. go to the overlay.
A bear came into the woods today. Oh, a bear fucking came.
Oh.
There's a bear in the fucking goddamn woods.
Shit, wait. I'm gonna set the overlay back to regular. I'll let Witch DD stay.
Yeah.
For a little bit.
For tonight.
Alright, window.
You made art. Art.
Art.
Alright.
If you breathe, you live.
Or.
Click. Alright. First piece. Well, working for sneak peek from JCaddy3. Sneak peek at an idea I had. Crochet DD. This is already a good start.
How on earth are you going to be able to do that?
I eagerly await.
I can't comprehend things like crocheting.
I know.
That drives me fucking wild.
My mom and my sister have been crocheting, like, up and down the past couple weeks.
That's going to be hype.
Making shit
Jake
for
had a good luck.
Making shit for our dogs. I'm looking forward to however this turns out. Thank you very much for other way. Next up from Tetraminus. I just had to.
Jennifer!
Oh, God. Why is he here?
Hey, check out these scissors I just got. Aren't they cool?
I didn't invite Nagito anywhere. You know he just fucking shows up. He can teleport now.
Why is he in your house?
he also lives there.
Hey!
Oh.
Hey, are you streaming?
No, Nagito,
no.
We're not streaming.
Okay. Go away, dude.
Thank you, Tetraminus. This is great. Next up, from Sea Salt Sky Art. Here's a quick doodle for Okie Dokie Art. It's Didi, but fucked up and evil. She has to be careful with those with those clippers, otherwise she'll hurt herself.
DD should not run with clippers.
She could maybe run with like a little pair of household scissors.
Those fucking plastic child scissors.
Yeah, she's got the child ones.
But with giant like Crayola scissors.
Or just like, I just imagine like a younger Bobby walking around with just regular like scissors everywhere. Like,
what is wrong with your kid?
It don't bite. Yes, it fucking do. It bit my hand off. thank you, Sky. This is very cute.
Really cute.
Next from Kuma_TM. Kuma.
Ooh.
Oh, Kuma.
I finally caught one of the Clock Tower streams live.
Cool. Yeah.
Fucking sweet, dude.
God.
We got
Kuma fucking rules.
Yeah, absolutely. We got Robbie and Jackson as little scissor fellas. DD as Jennifer getting chopped up. Clock Tower. This rules.
This is
really cool.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Also, in the replies. Oh fuck, oh shit. Who let the luck boy out of the art room with the scissors?
You better run, Jennifer! Here I come! Oh, no. I'm fucked up! I'm fucked up and crazy now!
thank you, Kuma. These are wonderful. Thank you very much.
Oh, I do have knee pads. Oh, that's the Sona. Oh.
Yeah, it's the Sona. You got the hair and you got the knee pads. thank you very much. I'm gonna do a quick refresh on the tag and see if we got anything else. We don't.
Kuma ended it out strong.
Ended it out on a high note. One sec.
What sec?
All right.
Sec.
Sona ref when? I don't know. When did I fucking sit down with Dev and pay Dev money?
when we finish it.
I feel like I threw a wrench in those plans.
You kind of did.
I'm sorry. You motherfucker. I had a good thing going.
I'm sorry. It came to me in a dream.
I love it.
All right. From Eve the Walrus. The shittiest little man. F. Is an, oh my god. Fuck, that scared me. Thank you for this little shitty man. That's great.
I love this little shitty guy.
I love this little shitty man. I think that's I guess that's gonna do it.
Chat, will that do it?
We did it.
And now, for one last,
which is a Fran dresser.
For one, again, you can't wait 5 seconds to wait for now to watch this screen change in real time.
Nobody say anything until it's changed.
Mm-hmm.
All right, it changed.
Wow.
So, I want to thank. Well, first of all, I want to thank all the lovely, beautiful people who came out to watch the streams. I hope you all had a wonderful time, because I sure did. More than I thought I would. I honestly expected this to be a one and done thing.
Clock Tower is neat.
Clock Tower is a cute little game. It's not a very complex game. It's relatively simple. Not a lot of moving parts. But the way that those moving parts are arranged and the different outcomes that can come forth from the way that you interact with things is a really novel idea for a game that came out the amount of time ago that it did. And I'm eager to play more, but with only however many days left of November, that's going to have to wait.
You're going to have to wait a whole year for November 10th.
Well, hopefully next time I will actually feel like streaming in October.
Right.
So hopefully I'll do it then. But look forward to more Clock Tower. I don't know what I'm streaming next. After this.
Fire Emblem 3.
Yeah, I'll start I'll get that English patch. I'll actually, you stream Fire Emblem, I'll stream Shining Force.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
I'll have to think about what I want to play next until other things start coming into play.
Color Splash.
No, god, not again. Can I tell you that I tried playing Color Splash after or like while I was pretty decent way into Origami King. I was like, out of curiosity, how does Color Splash hold up? God, it's so boring. Comparatively, it's so fucking boring, dude. Not even close.
It's very funny.
Yeah. So like I said, I'll have to think about what I want to play next as far as like a long form series. It may just go back to being a couple of one-offs until I figure things out. Either way, I was joined by two very lovely people, two very good friends of mine. I was joined by Jackson, aka Lumberjackson, or Lumberjack21, depending on where you look.
Hi.
Yeah, Lumberjack 2 on Twitch and Twitter. It won't give me the S.
Jackson.
Mm-hmm.
How you doing, bud?
Doing okay. Still grinding out for the PlayStation 5.
Yeah.
Voice is recovering from yesterday's Danganronpa experience.
Mm-hmm.
If I don't get a PlayStation 5 in the morning, because I was gonna do a funny PlayStation 5 stream when I got it, look forward to my Nekoparo stream.
So you're okay. So what I'm hearing is that if you don't get a place, if you don't get a PlayStation 5, your channel is getting shut down.
Yeah. So
if I don't get a PlayStation 5, it's over.
No, Friday I'm gonna do a poll in the morning and be like, what do you want to fucking see? And depending on what people want, because I still gotta
Skyrim.
No.
New Vegas.
Second maybe. No, but yeah, Friday, 20 fuck stream. We might go back to River City depending on how everybody's feeling. If not, I'll jump into like Bayo or Silent Hill 2 again.
Okay. Sounds good. Mm-hmm. And last but certainly not least, you know him, you love him, Robbie, aka Robbie Dude.
Hi.
How you doing, Robbie?
Doing great. Doing wonderful. Good. Congratulations on beating Clock Tower.
Thank you. Thank you. We all know what you got going on next, but you tell us, what do you got going on next?
I stream on Saturday at twitch.tv/RobbieDude if you wanted to go check that out. This Saturday, we are continuing with Fire Emblem 1 on the Famicom. We still got a week or two before it comes out in America officially. Yeah. So I greatly recommend you looking into ways that you could play.
Actually, it's very funny that you say that. It comes out in America in 1 week.
Great. You should check out my stream on Saturday. It's going to be a lot of fun. Fire Emblem's a hoot. I'm having a time playing it.
Yeah. I'm having a time being there with you.
Yeah, I'm joined by Dev if you wanted to hop in and hear some more Dev. But we're also joined by my friend Salty.
Resident Fire Emblem expert.
Yeah, genius. Fire Emblem genius. So yeah, you should come check that out. You should also check out my Twitter, twitter.com/RobbieDude. The best tweets on that website.
But no fleets.
You won't get a single fleet from me. So consider that a plus as well.
Yeah.
That's it.
Great. Awesome. Well, once again, thank you both very much for being here with me for these streams. Couldn't have done them without you. I'll see you all around. We are going to raid Mar. He is playing. Mar is playing an Earthbound randomizer. Oh my god, you literally just came in this room. Relax. Raid your friend Mar. The raid phrase will be, and Alfred's there too. Oh my god. Great. What was the raid phrase gonna be?
Happy ham.
Eat this ham.
Eat this ham.
Eat this ham.
Eat this eat the fucking ham.
Get back in the ham.
Get back in the eat this ham with the period.
Eat this ham, period. Alright. That's the raid phrase. Sending you over to Mar and Alfred. Earthbound randomizer. If you don't want to see Earthbound in some form, don't go there, but regardless. Again, thank you all very much for coming through. This is a wonderful time. I'll see you all next time, sometime next week. Goodbye!
Bong! 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 I'm doing like a clock tower thing. Bong! 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 All right. Bong!